Well, it might be a freezing weekend, but forget the snow. Melbourne supporters wouldn't be anywhere else than here at the MCG as they take on their most traditional of traditional rivals, Collingwood. These two sides played in five grand finals between 1955 and 1964, and now for the first time in the modern era, they meet when both are legitimate premiership contenders. At one end, Tarrant, Rocker, Buckley, Davis and Didak. At the other, Neats, Davey, Robertson and Uze. We can't wait for the bounce of the ball.
Team in black and white. Will a new contender reveal itself today? Can Melbourne, before the masses, against these magpies, with the football world watching, barnstorm its way into premiership calculations? Settle in. And hang on, because we're about to find out.
There is around town on a day when Australian sport will be on show to the world. The AFL's own showpiece stadium is playing host to a beauty, and the crowds has come in their tens of thousands, as you'd expect, to the MCG for this big Queen's Birthday's match between Melbourne and Collingwood. And welcome to Network 10's exclusive coverage. And welcome to you, Robert Walls. It should be a fantastic game.
Absolutely, Anthony. This is one I've been looking forward to. We've got two teams who are in terrific form. Collingwood, they've surprised everyone. They've got players back from injury this year, and they are making a statement. The Demons, on the other hand, they're young, they're hungry, they're very well coached by Neil Danaher, and they've really got themselves on a roll after a shaky start to the season.
Well, let's have a look at where they're placed on the ladder. What a crucial match this is for the win in particular. I mean, Collingwood could really clear out with West Coast and Adelaide at the top if they win.
Well, absolutely, and I think Collingwood are certainly top four material, and this young Melbourne team, well, they just continue to impress with the way that they're going, and they would certainly love to get a win today in front of this huge crowd.
Well, there they are, the Demons coming out of the ground, led by the record breaker of now goals and games. 8 goals last week. He was unbelievable, wasn't he? Couple of big outs over the weekend, though. Whelan and McLean.
Yes, and they'll miss Brock McLean. He's only young, but he's already an important part of this Melbourne team, particularly in close at the clearances. Matthew Whelan, of course, he's a veteran playing on that half-back line. They'll miss his dash. But Collingwood, they've got a few out as well, so it's evens out.
Yes, they have. We saw how important last week, though, that this Collingwood small men could be, so Whelan's loss could be quite significant. You've highlighted a couple of key players there.
Well, Byron Pickett, this is his third AFL club. Of course, he's played in premierships with the Kangaroos and Port Adelaide. He's made a real statement here, and the younger players just love playing with him. He's hard, he's aggressive, he tackles well. He's also playing some brilliant football, Aaron Davey, who's in the forward pocket, well, he's having a very good season also. He's amongst the goals, but he's the number one assist player for the Demons. Very lively, and the other part of his game, Arto, is that he runs the opposition down.
Well, there's the Magpies. Look at Nathan Buckley, fresh from 6 goals last week. Plenty of changes for them as well, of course. No Holland, Swan and Maxwell, as well as that Guy Richards not in the team. So Josh Fraser's going to have to ruck all day, but their fans are going to make plenty of noise as well as they come out onto the ground.
Well, they've been averaging 18 goals a game, this Collingwood side. We saw Buckley last week kick 6. He'll spend more time up in the forward line than ever before. And it's a pretty good goal-to-goal line that they've got there. We see Prestigiacomo, named at fullback, always gets the tough jobs. He'll probably play on Neach today. And then you go through, Wakeland's been in good form, Rocker and Tarrant, the key forwards. But Shane O'Bree, he's having a terrific season. Got himself really fit, winning the clearances and pumping the ball into the forward 50 for the Magpies.
All right, well, here's a man who played for both clubs. 138 times for Melbourne, he was a Brownlow medalist, and 52 times for the Magpies, of course, Shane Woden. And, paying tribute with a bit of a lap of honour, which is great to see.
That's terrific, Hutto, because, look, it's rare you can go to a ground and have the fans from both sides give you a clap and a cheer, and that's what Shane's getting today here at the MCG. Wonderful player with Melbourne, Brownlow medalist, as you mentioned, played in a grand final for Collingwood when he went there.
All right, well, the crowd, as we said, is continuing to build up. These two sides, they once had 99,000 for a home and away game. Well, so we might not quite get there today, but it's going to be a great atmosphere. Just in a word, who are you tipping?
Collingwood.
Collingwood. So Robert Wall's going for Collingwood. The fans are here in their numbers. We can't wait once again for the bounce of the ball. We'll be back in just a moment on Network 10.
A cross won't repel them. Sunlight won't kill them. And neither will stake to the heart.
So what are they? They're vampires.
Ooh.
Nightcrawlers, bloodsuckers. The brothers are taking on a demonic legend.
Vampires? I thought there was no such thing.
But have Dean and Sam bitten off more than they can chew?
I don't normally get this friendly till the second date, but...
Brand new Supernatural, 8:40 tonight.
These guys look like they need a bit of a lift to keep them going, so I've prepared a little something with a few things I found around the place. So we've got some prawns on the go in here.
Where'd that bait get to, Pete? Put out in the sun to thaw out yesterday.
Oh. Actually, the best way to fill blokes up is with a bit of this. Let's just let go of that.
Campbell's, the experts in soup.
Mmm, that is, you know, good. Just don't touch that. How's the fishing? Still nothing?
I've always tried to give back to my fans, so I'm on the home phone a lot.
Yeah, you wrote to me in 1975.
I switch into Primus Home Cap, I've saved more than $50 a month.
Beverly? Madeline? Yes, Susie, it's Leo Sayer.
Changing was easy. I just called Primus and they helped me select the best plan.
The singer, you know.
With Primus's everyday low rates, I can make loads more calls.
Yeah. You gotta go.
Call 1-300-PRIMUS now and find out how much you can save.
That's more like it.
AFL is back on 10 in 2006. Harvey Norman brings the stadium to your home. Get front row seats for today's big game on 10 with this incredible widescreen experience. Get yourself into the thrilling live atmosphere of Panasonic's widescreen plasma TVs and home theater systems. Grab a winning deal today from Harvey Norman. AFL on 10. Seriously.
He'll call in the air when you're ready, Stuart. It is Good luck.
Welcome back to the MCG, where we just saw the two captains and the two sharpshooters in the coin toss. Between them, they both kicked 14 goals last week, 8 to David Neates and 6 to Nathan Buckley. Will it be another high-scoring affair? Will they kick another bundle of goals? We'll have to wait and see. But I can tell you that the breeze down here won't help them. It is quite a strong breeze, but really very swirly, so it won't give any side an advantage. It'll just make it difficult for them to get deliver it into those tall marking forwards. The surface seems to be in pretty good condition despite the fact that we have had some rain. It's not too slippery, it's actually quite sticky. They are predicting some rain to fall later in the day, hopefully not until after the game though.
Thanks very much, Christy. Yes, looking forward to this game. As we say, a very good afternoon to Stephen Silvani and Soss. Both sides have played 5 times at the MCG this year and they've won all 5 of them. So looking forward to a cracker this afternoon.
Should be a super crowd, super game as well today. Obviously, it's interesting to see that Collingwood have started a lot of their youngsters on the bench. Rowe, Thomas, Pendlebury and also Agabuchi. So Mick Malthouse has opted to go with experience out on the ground.
Anthony Rocker, Ben Holland's got the job on Anthony Rocker. Nathan Buckley has gone to the goal square and going back to pick up Nathan Buckley. Buckley is Nathan Carroll. So the Queen's birthday clash, Collingwood versus Melbourne from the MCG. Fraser to battle with White. White gets it down and there's an early free kick. Which way will it go?
Your kick. Grabbing in, Phillip.
So an early free kick to O'Bree.
Back here.
Now
it's. Yeah. Holding on at the bounce.
McBurney getting the message across as O'Bree, long just inside attacking down, 50. Big leap from Rocker. Davis up there. Brilliant stuff. Can he kick the first goal? He can. Electrifying stuff from Leon Davis. And he's kicked the opening goal in the opening seconds of this big match at the MCG.
Well, just great play. Long and direct they went. And that's the added bonus that Collingwood does have. They've got the taller forwards. And Davis and Didak are the ones that are going to go front and square. And we just see Davis there on that occasion just reading it so well off the pack. And a super goal.
Yeah, it's a wonderful finish. Clint Bartram, been a wonderful first-year player for the Demons with the job on Leon Davis.
And just with a couple of forward lines set up for the Collingwood. Bruce has got Tarrant, Holland's got Rocker, Carroll's got Buckley.
So White dumps it forward. Johnston, good pressure from Burns. Pickett can't control. Jack. Kick forward by McDonald. High towards half forward. Wakeland comes to meet it. Can't take it. Davey, a snap it. Kick the goal square. Morrison now, one out on Uze. Well done, Morrison. Retrieved it brilliantly. Lucuria, Shaw pulled off the ball. There's still a chance for the Demons. Uze, Pickett can kick. Melbourne's opening goal, and he misses to the left. Gee, would have been a great start for Byron Pickett, but just the one behind. So the Magpies early by 5 points.
And we just saw that the pace by Aaron Davey, the forward line pressure that he was so good at.
Lockyer with a clearing kick finds Heath Shaw across half back, flowing on nicely for Loney, and the Magpies to the wing without any problems.
Thanks,
Fraser. Very potent forward line. Holland, what a task for him on Rocker. Lagging behind there. Didak, not in bad position. Holland and Bell collaborate. White, now Bartram, and they're onto the wing. Not a good kick. The odds were against Russell Robertson on that occasion.
Well, it wasn't a smart kick. 2-1, and Russell Robertson, as good as he is in the air, he's not going to beat Josh Fraser in that front spot.
Clement. Didak backed his judgment by staying at the back of the pack. Uses his wrong boot. Not great disposal. Bruce couldn't handle it. Didak ready to bounce up again. Was that holding the ball? No. Carroll, White. And now the Demons can group off half-back. Bruce in unfamiliar territory today. Finds Carroll and now to half-forward Neates. That was fantastic ball handling. Too hot though for Dunn. Wakeland. And the ball is over and out. Some fascinating matchups today, Soss.
Well, there is. Just up in the Melbourne forward line, Lockie's got Davey, Christa Giacomo's gone to Neates, and Clement's gone to Robertson.
Fraser and White, that'll be an enthralling battle. White gets it down towards Green. Good pressure coming from Johnson. And over, so a boundary thrown at half four to the Dees.
A bit of a surprise in the Melbourne forward line is that Morrison's gone to Uze, which is a bit of a surprise. Obviously, Uze, very smart footballer. Morrison's going to have to watch him closely.
Uze kicked 5 goals in this game last year.
Fraser in front. White gets it down. The Courier goes in to get it. Well done. Quick handball at close quarters to Burns. Now Fraser. Handball a little loose. Well done by Lockyer. Got his body in. Travis Cloak now involved. From the wing towards half forward. Rocker one out with Holland. Ineffective play. Well done by Holland. Knocked it wide. Only as far as Dynette. Good pressure though from Bell. Rocker can't control it. Disputed football. Well done, Carroll. Great strength there. Just wrenched it free. Got it to Bruce, who clears. And McDonald now at half-back for the Demons.
One of the form Demons, and there's another. Johnston. Normally so good by foot. Just flicked off the travel. And then goes for Jeff White. Reed in the team for his first game for the year. As it turned out, it was a perfectly placed kick for Green. A few nervous moments for the Demon fans now. So dominating last week with eight. Accepts a nice pass on the chest.
Just a terrific bit of Melbourne play. Coming off that half back line, they get it into the centre corridor as quickly as they can. Transferred to Green, who in turn able to put it out in space in front of Neitz.
19 goals, 5 from set shots for the year for David Neitz. Pretty good odds.
It's the end of financial year, and people who know their numbers know now's the time to buy Toyota.
Seven-seat
Kluger all-wheel drive V6 CV Auto, now just $39,990. Four-wheel drive Prado GXL petrol or turbo diesel from just $49,990.
One.
The number one event from Australia's number one car company. Get in now while Toyota means business.
Really bold move this, Steve, having Bruce play on Tarrant. Not many would have expected that.
So ball back in the centre. Melbourne in front. Well done, Fraser. Got it to O'Bree. Hurries the kick to Cloak. Real good tackle on him by Rivers. Ties it up. Ball going nowhere.
Better bounce. Just held to him. Good tackle, Garrett.
At half forward, umpire James. Fraser again. Tap intended for Loney. Shark though by Johnston. He hurries the kick towards half forward. Clement on Robertson. That'll be a wonderful battle. Well done, Clement, on this occasion. Wakeland in support. Shaw in turn available. And his chip is okay. Mark taken by Lockyer at half back for the Magpies.
So Tarkin Lockyer averages around the 20 possession mark a game. Fairly bold with the pass into Cloak, who's back in the team today. Nick Travis.
Play on!
Goes to another one-on-one. Johnson got into position A. Well done from Green. Morrison there as the backup. Now Heath Shaw. Likes to carry it, but couldn't get past Johnson that time. Onto the back foot. Morrison trying to clean up. Magpies a little fumbly here. Rivers bearing down on Lockyer. Neitz. He's got Pickett away. They should be able to get a goal out of this. Will Pickett go back or... He will.
Well, we just see Pickett there. His direct opponent is Heath Shaw, and he was ready to run through the middle of the ground there, but it was the turnover that hurt Collingwood there, and Pickett was able to read it best and find some space in their forward 50.
So Byron Pickett has produced a lot of assists, as you saw there, equal first for Melbourne with assists. Hasn't kicked an enormous amount of goals himself for the Demons. Just 4 goals, 1 for the year, but he's come up with a big one at a crucial stage.
Right, money, we're off. We'll see you at the party.
Yeah, no worries, fellas.
Bye.
I'll see you there. Clever, fellas. Very clever.
I like a bloke who's man enough to wear pink. Come meet my friends.
Sure. Cheers for the fashion tip, fellas. Classic.
Jeff White off the ground. J-Mub on for the Demons. Fraser up early. Gets it down towards O'Bree.
Didn't have the footy.
Free kick. Going Collingwood's way. Shane O'Bree. So the Magpies with the opening goal in the opening seconds of the match from Leon Davis. But since then it's been Melbourne with the last couple.
Gee, Melbourne getting numbers back. Melbourne have only got two players in their forward half, making it hard for Collingwood to find space.
Clement, Shaw, now Lucuria, Buckley on the lead. Oh, he couldn't take it. Now a chance for Bruce, cleverly around Lockyer. Wobbles the kick out wide. Wakelin in good position. Against Dunn. Wakelin tracks it to the line. Does he keep it in? Yes, he does. Well played. Good strength. No, it's over. Boundary throw in between wing and half forward for the Magpies.
Well, there's a shot of Aaron Davey, and he's been roaming around the half back line for the Demons.
There's those crucial matchups, and that's some of them interesting. Holland on Rocker, of course. Holland last week playing on Fraser Gehrig. We'll keep running through those so you can get an idea of who's playing on who as the Magpies go forward. Didak, oh, Bell, left in his wake. Should be an easy Collingwood score here, Burns, to have a shot for goal.
Typical Alan Didak. Just about 9 times out of 10 when he gets a mark, it is just automatic play on, and it really throws the opposition out. Of course, his teammates know what he'll do. He's predictable to them. Have a look at this. Mark, bounce, hit the ground, and I'm off.
Scotty Burns, 29 possessions last week, his season best. 5 goals for the year. And the Magpies, who have a very potent forward line, just haven't really got it together down there yet. What do you think of all those matchups down there, Wolsey, in the Collingwood forward line? I mean, some big tasks for the Melbourne players, aren't there?
Look, the one that's really surprising is Cameron Bruce on Tarrant. Now, you need Bruce in the midfield, particularly without Brock McLean, but I reckon it might be a matchup that just is there for the first half. We'll have to wait and see how it unfolds. This is interesting, Steve. Phil Reid coming into the team and doing a very tight tag on O'Brien.
Yeah, I reckon it's a good decision because there is a question mark on whether O'Brien can handle a hard tag.
So a great kick from Reid to Bruce. A couple of early touches for Cameron Bruce. Chips it short. J-Mart. Well done. Good handball off to McDonald. Now Travis Johnston confronted by Lucuria. Slipped the tackle. Johnston normally uses it very well. Kick to half on Clement. Too good. Off to Davis. Now he's got a loose player on the wing. Southern wing, Didak in space. On the non-dominant side, chips it over the top to the captain. Buckley, 60 from goal, looks for Tarrant and Rocker. Ball to the back. Big clash of bodies in there. Chance for Bell, Rivers it was. Intercepted now, Tarrant. Dribbling effort is good. Wonderful goal from Chris Tarrant. Great start that. And big contest, 20 metres from the Collingwood goal. As we look at the kick come in from Buckley, but it was the recovery of the Collingwood players that was very good, Steve.
Oh, spot on, but there was a great little tackle there by Thomas, and he puts a little block on, but Tarrant's goal there was absolute class.
And it was needed by the Magpies to get Buckley and Tarrant to get a feel of the footy. Their first couple of touches were 11 minutes in.
Change already, Rob.
I just thought that Buckley started deep at full forward. I would have thought it would be better to get Buckley into the action. Buckley now in at this centre bounce. Get him in there, get a few touches, then drop him forward.
So Bruce going with Buckley in the midfield. Carroll back in more familiar territory, playing against Tarrant, who's kicked one of the first couple of goals. Advantage will go Collingwood. No advantage, but the free kick will go Collingwood's way.
The problem with the Carroll matchup on Tarrant, Carroll's not overly quick. And we know what type of speed Tarrant's got.
Well, the ball doesn't get there. Well done by Dunn. Equally, the points must go to Shaw, although his handball not handled well by Davis, as you saw. Bartram in on top of it. This is Johnson trying to wade his way through. Maloney likewise. Gang tackle.
You had to admire the way that Melbourne went at the Collingwood players there. They fumbled Collingwood. In the end, a free kick saves the Pies.
4 free kicks to Collingwood, none to Melbourne. Lockyer takes it, immediate looks up. Fraser's down there, testing Ben Holland out. Here's a Rocker who gets to the front. 4 Demons against him. Who's down? That's the question. Davey left it behind, and Didak did it. Thomas.
Free kick, Didak.
Holding the arm here against you. You held his arm.
Against Didak.
He's fire.
Gee, that though.
I think the umpire said Didak pulled the Demon player down. Interesting.
So Reid got it in the back pocket. Chips it back to Pickett. Yes. So Melbourne trying to find a way forward. Loose player inside the centre square, Bartram. What a find he's been. Drafted number 60 in last year's national draft. played every game. Kick towards half forward, one out, Robertson, and Clement again pushes Robertson under the ball and Mark strongly.
Well, he's been good, Clement, early. Melbourne have really struggled to get the ball inside their forward 50.
Mercurio, not 15, so Ben Johnson called to play on. Driving kick out wide. Oh, Didak, Bell wasn't even watching the footy.
Exactly, Bell was asleep.
So Didak now forced to track back to Lucuria, Loney in support now. There's no one forward of the play here for Collingwood. Pickett alone in the defensive goal square as Lucuria gives it back to Loney. Lockyer, going to be patient here, Collingwood. Work their way through. Now O'Bree. Now he drives it long. Buckley in the contest. Chipping in front. Well done by the Melbourne defence. Now Bates. Pickett. And he uses it effectively in green marks at half-back for Melbourne.
Gee, Melbourne intent on getting numbers back and stopping the Collingwood scoring. More intent on stopping Collingwood scoring than scoring themselves at the moment.
Clint Bartram takes the mark. Played every game this year. What a great performance it's been. Now Bruce takes it from White to half-forward. Needs two to beat. Should be able to.
It's a great kick. Two against one. Needs
Chris Johnson pushing forward. Done down there as well. Other than that, it's mainly Magpie jumpers, so not a lot on offer here for Jeff White. He'll be reluctant to go to a Robertson Clement one-on-one, so back he goes for Pickett. Neitz is slowly working his way down there. Maybe that's what they're waiting for. Uzay also on a lead. Dunn and Wakelin.
Well, they took it from one side to the other, desperately hoping in the end they could set up a mark inside the forward 50, not to be.
Bell, looks like Bell's coming off. Godfrey going onto the ground. And Ward, I think, might be going back onto Didak. So already plenty of renovations to the Melbourne defence, Rob.
Yes, interesting, isn't it? Carroll switching around.
And Didak, Ward didn't have time to get to him. He's his new opponent. You'll see Ward on screen in just a moment. There he is, just come on the ground. So wasn't a great time for the change-up. Allowed Collingwood to have a free man. Haven't made the most of it. Bartram, bit of friendly fire to overcome. Carroll, and now Byron Pickett. Better watch out from behind. They're coming, but he has got speed like almost no other. He can put it down. And this time Robertson's got away from Clement. Clement comes.
Mick Malthouse will be pretty annoyed with Leon Davis not chasing Byron Pickett. There was a stage when Pickett received that handball. He was only about 3 metres in front of Leon Davis. Davis just decided not to go. It left little Thomas to do it by himself. He was just brushed away in a shepherd. And in these big games, in fact, in all games, you've just got to go.
Hasn't been a big goal kicker against Collingwood, Russell Robertson. 8 goals in 6 games. He did kick 3 last year.
Yeah, we got a tool shop here. It's pretty good in there. I go in there sometimes to grab a tape measure or something, spend 15 minutes walking around, thinking about the things I wouldn't mind picking up when I get paid.
Bosch lithium ion cordless driver, $66. Outdoor bistro blinds, $125. GMC 1800 watt electric chainsaw, $99. 12 rail clothes error, $690. If you happen to find a cheaper price on a stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
Pretty hard to come in and not see something that you need. Bunnings
Warehouse. Lowest prices are just the beginning.
So Collingwood doing well out of the centre. Clearances 4-1, 7-2 overall. Umpire McBurney restarts play. Fraser, shark by Bruce, quick handball, effective. Godfrey, though, is well tackled by Loney. Wakelin will almost throw it out to short. And the umpire's seen it. Free kick to Melbourne.
Wide view, but he had a good view of it.
So umpire McBurney just letting Shane Wakelin know, and there. You could see it, so yeah. No argument there.
Stay there, Leon. Don't go through.
So done from 55.
Stay there, Leon.
Clouded forward 50 for the Demons. Play on called. Thumping kick to the goal square. Neitz and Presta Giacomo. Presta Giacomo did enough. And it's over the line for a force behind. And the Collingwood fans having some words of advice for David Neitz.
Leon Davis has just been told to get off the ground.
Fabulous crowd at the MCG, as you'd expect for this Holiday Monday game, with both these two sides in fine form. Travis Cloak accepts the Buckley pass. We notice Godfrey's gone on to Buckley. A couple of old combatants going at it again. Fraser pushing forward, testing Jeff White. This is Yakabuchi into the Collingwood team this week. And a host of changes. Lightning stuff, Didac to Morrison. Loney away. And missing.
And Didac on fire at the moment. 8 disposals already. He's already had Bell go to him. And Ward looks like who's his second opponent.
One of the form players in the competition, really, isn't he, over the last month or so, Didac?
Just been good, the Demons, with the pressure, harassment that they put on Collingwood. Their tackling has been so strong, has been for most of this season, continues on in this all-important first quarter.
So Ward, amble out wide to accommodate Carroll. The casual bounce as he runs through half-back, assesses his option. Chip kick is okay. Oh, a little fumble there from Davey. It's okay, though. Mark Pate kicks the ball inside to Bartram, who's loose. Good overlap provided by Jeff White. Oh, wobbles it. It's good enough, though. Got to Rivers in midfield. Now, hasn't got much to go to. Now Neitz goes for him. Little slip from Preston Giacomo and drops the mark, David Neitz. Good pressure from Preston Giacomo, who needs to get the ball clear. And he'll get the free kick for a push in the back.
Just saw again Melbourne taking it from the back flank into the centre corridor and then out to the opposite half forward flank. Do it very well. Use the corridor at half back.
Neitz protesting. Pendlebury, meantime, with the footy. We saw him make his debut last week. Impressed everyone. Now Morrison looking to get some run and some dart off the wing from Burns. Linking up well with Tarrant. Ignored Loney. Goes for Fraser. Again, pushing Jeff White inside the forward 50.
Now, Jeff White took his eyes off the football, concentrated on his opponent, needed to go for the ball.
And this is what Josh Fraser will do. He'll push deep into the forward line for the Magpies. And very well judged mark there.
6 goals, 8 from set shots for the year for Josh Fraser. 8-12 all in all. Is a goal kicker, though. Not on this occasion. And the Magpies inch closer. 5 points the difference. Both sides really testing each other out. Interesting that Neil Danaher has made the number of moves he has already, Walsy. At times he's been criticised in the past for being slow with his moves.
You're right, Hutto. He's been on the front foot, and I think that's terrific to see. And even now he's just loaded his back line with players. If they can get a break from this kick in, it's a very, very open forward line.
So Green called to play on, kicked under pressure in the end. O'Brien at the back. Can't control it. Good effort by Rivers, Godfrey, Davey. And now Rivers in space at half-back for Melbourne, delivers onto the chest of Ward. So Melbourne now with an opportunity. They've got a spare man, Bruce. Handball over the top, long towards Robertson. Oh, well done, Clement, applying the pressure again. Gee, the boundary throw-in.
What a contest between these two. And there's Anthony Rocker in picture. He hasn't had a touch. Nobody really thought Ben Holland would get that job. He's done a superb job in this first quarter.
So Fraser, favoured by the bounce, the boundary thrown. Yakabuchi wrestled to the ground, and the umpire calls for it.
Tackled as soon as he got it.
Jared Rivers playing effectively as the floater back there, Soss. I mean, he's pretty good at that job, isn't he?
Well, that's one of his real strengths, his reading of his play and his ability to get across and spoil for his teammates.
Play on!
So, free kick to Fraser, advantage play. Now Buckley, who started at full forward, kick around the body, was deaf. Now to O'Brien, he's got a loose player out wide, Heath Shaw. A little fumble, seen a little bit of that from Collingwood this afternoon, but now he's got it. A couple of bounces, Tarrant moves for him. Big Shepherd off the ball, is illegal. And it's a Melbourne free kick.
Straight back! Here, Heath, two more!
City had on his arm, I think. Chris, that?
Yours, Manny.
Chris Johnson, who's impressed over the last couple of weeks. Takes the free kick. Gee, mate, Dunn really have to put in the hard ones, which he did. On Wakeland, he's a likely type, isn't he, Dunn? Now, Neitz has to work hard at ground level.
This is where they take the pass.
Pendlebury through the middle. Here's Didac. Oh, unlikely mistake to make. Usually such a short ball handler.
Rocker's advantage. Rocker free kick, advantage paid.
Bree kicks it behind. The umpire committed to the advantage. Rocker saying, well, hang on, there was no advantage.
A big Anthony Keane to get a touch. Gee, they're making some errors, Collingwood. So just some blatant skill errors.
So McDonald this time with the kick in to Ward. Further afield to Bate. And plenty of space, Matthew Bate at halfback. Confronted by Thomas. He slipped the tackle okay, though, with the left boot. Searching kick towards Bruce. Hard up against the line. Loose player inside Holland. So the Melbourne side here, a big chance as Holland kicks towards the lead of Neaton. Finds him on attacking 50. He's got a wonderful skill, David Neaton, kicking long goals. And this will be a challenging one for him. Well played and good run by Ben Holland.
Yeah, and Cameron Bruce, red hot, 9 touches.
This time he kicks to the hot spot. At the back, oh, Rivers, a big leap. Morrison, though, at ground level. Lockyer has got anywhere to go, so he'll be forced to go back across his defensive goal face. He uses Pendlebury. Game number 2, and his kick is precise to Shaw. Now Clement. He hasn't got much to go to either, but he picks out Iacobucci, who marks at half back.
Thanks, Simon.
Uze came up looking a bit second-hand too from that clash a few moments ago as Rowe takes the mark for the Magpies. Another one into the team today.
Yours!
Shaw instantly played on. Didn't realise that Robertson was so close. And now the world starts to cave in around him. Awareness good though. And there's Presty pushing out. And O'Brien's away. Bate in pursuit. Tarrant got it. Good safe ball movement by the Magpies. And will favour the left side here of Chris Tarrant.
And this is what Chris Tarrant just needs to do all day. Just keep presenting. Obviously got Carroll. And Carroll, as I mentioned earlier, not overly quick. And they've just got to reward his leading, the Magpies.
And again, O'Brien, 8 possessions. Has been a fine player. Tarrant after a week off. Can put the Magpies back in front, but is unable to. And once again, inaccurate in front of goal. Collingwood, 7 scoring shots to 5, but they trail by 3.
Haven't settled Collingwood in this first quarter. Big match, big crowd. Melbourne, on the other hand, a lot of young players, but they're doing it well.
James McDonald kicks towards half-back, and the mark's taken by Bate. So they bring it out effectively on this occasion. Ticking down to quarter time. Matthew Bateman, a real find for the Demons. Season 2006. Long towards half forward. Travis Cloak in front. Ball kicked forward by Pickett into a dangerous position. But Lockie will be first back. He's got support from Shaw. And Shaw, pursued by Davey. Look out. And he's penalised. Zink when he should have zagged. And Aaron Davey from 50 with an opportunity.
He was actually sweating on who saw to take him on.
Yeah, he didn't commit to getting close to him, did he?
And the Melbourne fans just love this fella with the footy. And not just for his tricks, but for what we saw there, the hard stuff, the rundowns.
Well, a chance after the siren to put the Demons further in front. 4-3 from set shots this year, but hasn't kicked a goal for a couple of weeks. From outside 50. After the siren at quarter time, Aaron Davey makes it count. Superb effort. And Melbourne now at quarter time by 9 points.
Well, a terrific start to the game by the Demons. I reckon they deserve to get that last one there, Steve, because they've come out, put real pressure on the Magpies. Collingwood have been fumbling. Melbourne have got players back in their defensive area. Made it hard for the Magpies to find players in space. They've gone for Rocker. They've gone for Tarrant. They've gone for Buckley. And we've seen those stars drop marks and get crowded. And you've got to say coaching points to Neil Danaher at this stage.
Big game this afternoon. The Demons lead here on Channel 10. It's not always serious.
I mean, I've got to say, you are one of the coolest cats going around in the coaching business.
That's, see, Sam? That's pumping me up.
You gave me nothing. You gave me nothing.
Good afternoon, Luke Waters looking ahead to 10 News. A rape survivor adds her voice to the calls for new DNA laws to be made retrospective. We meet the Adelaide researchers trying to prevent the spread of a silent killer lurking in air conditioning towers. And the king of the clay, Rafael Nadal, topples world number one Roger Federer to reclaim the French Open title.
Hello.
housemates, but it's time to nominate.
He's nastier.
And more severe.
Than ever before.
Is this the week he's going to come down hard?
The plot thickens.
Live nominations from 7 o'clock tonight on 10.
Right, Bunny, we're off. We'll see you at the party.
Yeah, no worries, fellas.
Bye.
I'll see you there. Clever, fellas. Very clever.
I like a bloke who's man enough to wear pink. Come meet my friends.
Sure. Cheers for the fashion tip, fellas.
Classic.
It's our 10th birthday at Primus, and to celebrate, we've got a broadband plan for you. You pay only $10 installation, $10 for a modem, and $10 per month for the first 3 months. All on our huge 5-gig, super-fast 512K broadband plan when you combine your home phone with Primus. So, start the year with a bang. Call Primus on 1300 Primus. That's 1300 774687.
You know what I love about Subway restaurants? Same thing you do. Great tasting food and lots of it. They've got tons of choices, so you can get something different every day. I'm gonna go check out what deal they have today. Now this is a deal worth walking all the way across town for.
The $3.50 daily special. Every day, a different delicious, great tasting 6-inch Subway sub on fresh baked bread, fresh toasted and made the way you like it for just $3.50. 7 days, 7 great 6-inch subs, all for the one daily special price of just $3.50.
Subway, eat fresh.
A number of things can go wrong in life, so it's reassuring to know that a call to one number will set your mind at rest. Don't discover our benefits by accident. Call 133 QBE.
Over 60,000 new season garments must be liquidated. It's the unrivaled largest designer denim and fashion brand sale in the Southern Hemisphere. Designer jeans from a ridiculous $15 at Duncan Hall Adelaide Showgrounds from this Thursday at midday.
Psst. Do you like a good puzzle?
A meat puzzle.
This puzzle might open up some old wounds. Are you scared?
Yes, I'm scared.
It's time for revenge. NCIS, 9:30 Wednesday.
Network 10 Adelaide would like to thank the support of their local sponsors. Stratco, what do you need today? Make it your way. Subway, eat fresh. Truscott's and TIAC, the plasma LCD and surround sound specialists. And Booze Brothers, proudly South Australian owned.
CG Holiday Monday, and it's the Demons with their noses in front. 4-2, 26, 2-5, 17. A few unexpected errors made by the Magpies, but a terrific contest. Look at this, boys. Mick Mulder straight to Heath Shaw. This is just after the siren sounded at quarter time. Yeah, Nathan Buckley comes across, but
I just wonder whether it was for the bounce he took in the back 50 and Aaron Davey tackled him and resulted in Melbourne's last goal. But I think the young ball just have to realise it is a high-pressure game and that you haven't got much time deep in these big games.
We've got to get down to Christy Malthouse, who's going to show us her colours, Christy.
Thank you, Anthony. Yes, this is an initiative by the Melbourne Football Club. Every person that came through the gate today got given one of these with the colours of both teams on either side, and it is supposed to show Melbourne supporters, supposed to show their support for the team and to say that this is their ground, so back off Collingwood. But I hate to say it, when you look around, there are definitely more black and white posters being held up, and show us your colours, here are mine.
Very biased view from down on the boundary line. Nathan Buckley getting some work done. Started deep in attack, and these have been some of the moves that have been interesting. That one, Rocker and Holland particularly was.
Yes, and Ben Holland's done a terrific job. Anthony hasn't had a touch of the footy to this stage.
Josh Fraser, who's carrying the ruck load on his own this afternoon against the combination of White and J-Mart. Fraser with the tap, White with the last word, though. This is the matchup that's so interesting. The speedster Shaw and Pickett. J Johnston through Bate. Reed, McCurry, a few tough nuts in there. McDonald in a bounce.
Yeah, right, right. Yep.
Five possessions for Nathan Buckley in the opening quarter. No goals. Coming off six from last week.
Around the stoppage.
Davey. Didak ready, but no one could stop him. Davey, longer full forward. Neats! You know what I love about Subway restaurants? Same thing you do. Great tasting food and lots of it. They've got tons of choices, so you can get something different every day. I'm gonna go check out what deal they have today. Now this is a deal worth walking all the way across town for.
The $3.50 daily special. Every day, a different delicious, great-tasting 6-inch Subway sub on fresh baked bread, fresh toasted and made the way you like it for just $3.50. 7 days, 7 great 6-inch subs, all for the one daily special price of just $3.50.
Subway. Eat fresh.
Well, there's Byron Pickett and Heath Shaw, and Pickett and Aaron Davey winning the clearances for the Demons. And when they win the clearances, they play very good football, as we've just seen with the last couple of breaks.
Another set of clearance for the Demons. Reed. Wakeland got a little toe poke in there. Dunn over the footy. Taps it out. Now Morrison. Wild kick from the pack. Just past Ben Johnson, who throws it out to Rowe. It's okay, said the umpire. Boundary throwing between wing and half forward for the Demons. Julian Rowe playing his first game of the year for the Magpies.
Ben Johnson just 4 possessions.
Well down on his usual output.
So White.
Play on, play on!
Aerial ball, well done by Shaw. Wrested it from Green. Kicks around the body. Ball bouncing towards half forward. Davis in front. Eludes both he and his opponent. Well done, Tarrant. Gave it to Pendlebury, who was manned up by Ward. Well done, good pressure from Tarrant, who takes Carroll over. So a boundary throwing close to half forward for the Magpies.
Leon Davis, this is a big game for him. He's had a good start to the season, but in big matches he hasn't fired. A couple of grand finals, and this is a big one today.
Ball in dispute. Well done by Chris Johnson, but a good tackle in turn by Josh Fraser, and about 65 metres from the Collingwood goal.
...15 points the difference. Fraser and White. And again, White trying to farm it down. The two ruckmen having to do the roving as well. Johnson finally emerging with a good little outlet give to Burns, but Rivers, who works the space so well, fearless, sometimes gets himself into trouble with injury because of his carriage. Now McDonald. White's got away. Waiting for the next option. Ben Holland's actually pushed forward. He's got a chop out from a teammate in Rivers, who's gone back to play on Rocker for the moment. So Carroll takes it, can go across to Rivers. So I wonder whether the Ben Holland, whether there's been a move there or it's just happened in transition. Rivers now can go to Bartram, who's nullified the effect of Davis since the opening minute. Dunn and Wakeland further ahead. Pickett on the wing.
They do not want to kick to a contest.
Move it on.
The last thing they want to do is kick it to a contest. The Demons, they've had to eventually. But I reckon they're thinking that we'll have a look at that down there. That's the Melbourne forward setup. Those two very good players, Neats and Robertson, deep in the forward line. Everybody else up outside the 50.
White in front, wins it down. Mercuria. Little handball. Was just got a hand in there. Well done by Chris Johnson. O'Bree fighting hard at ground level. Well done by McDonald. Rested it free. Kicks it inside attacking 50. Wakeland with great courage. Bruce Ball. Rowe. Well, kept his composure very well there, Julian Rowe. The left boot kicks towards the Bartram-Davis matchup. On ground level, Davis with superior speed. Now he's got time to weigh up his options. Kicks towards half or Dynak at the back. Couldn't take the mark. Play onto the court. Ward. Pickett has been very good. Chips it short. White. Now Reed. So Melbourne now with an opportunity. Kicks to a vacant half forward line. Robertson comes out, but getting back to assist Lockyer.
Wakeland down. Got injured in that contest with David Neats before.
He's coming off.
Burns. Loose player on the wing is Ben Johnson. So the Magpies an opportunity here. Cruising past Rowe. And he delivers okay. Mark taken by Lucuria. Now Ben Johnson kept going. Handball over the top. Needs to get an accommodating bounce and does it. But he goes back in and finds it. Pendlebury hard up against the line. Oh, slip the tackle of Johnson. Kicks across the face and out on the foot.
Shane Wakeland off. Hurts the Magpies. Courageous attempt to go back there. Got a feeling he might have twisted the ankle or knee. David Neitch collecting him mid-air.
Well, it was just one of those horrific old-fashioned circumstances, Rob, that you really wouldn't want to be in with Neitch charging out. And he's a fearsome sight. Ben Holland takes the mark. Goes to Johnson. Magpies with numbers through the middle, so Johnson forced to go laterally.
They're just hanging onto the football, the Demons. Umpire called play on here.
I heard the explanation. Misfire from Travis Johnston. Don't see that too often. Burns, imprecise with the handball. Time for Fraser. Didak, who's on him? No one at the moment. He can swing onto his left. The trusty left of Alan Didak produces a goal when the Magpies needed one.
Sunday, the home of great Australian stories, presents a much talked about world movie premiere.
We're trying to find the murderers who killed our mother.
A family under police suspicion.
A family under public scrutiny.
A family whose secrets will shock you.
Why isn't anyone on our side?
Georgie Parker.
Alex Dimitriadis.
And Matthew Leneves.
The Society Murders, 8:30 Sunday on 10.
Neil Danaher will be pretty pleased, I think, with the way things are travelling. 9 points the advantage to Melbourne. Early stages, second term. White gets it down, looking for Reid, but Fraser's second effort was superb. Handball out wide to Lucuria. Oh, he took a long time to get rid of it, but did effectively in the end to Burns. Rowe, kick run down by Uze. Chance for Melbourne, though, bounces back to Lucuria. Burns, lead coming from Tarrant, gets there, no, couldn't hold on. Well done, Ward to Reid, the Green. And Melbourne out of trouble perhaps for the moment. Good tackle though from Johnson, putting the pressure on. Burns' little give is okay. Ben Johnson, Didak again, kicks it short. Tarrant slipped over this time. Things not going right for Chris Tarrant. Holland, Reid, and a clearing kick is marked by McDonald.
Demons galore at halfback. Now some of them starting to run through the middle. Davey, little flick of the switch, gave it across the bait. Runs his full measure and then some and gives it everything he's got. And that's enough.
Some brothers are famous for their driving prowess. We're famous for great booze prices. Like Crown Lager, just $43.99 a carton. Choose any two bottles of Ballantine Scotch Whiskey, Smirnoff Vodka, Cougar Bourbon or St Agnes 5-year-old VSOP Brandy for only $50. Or Berry 5-litre casks, just $18 a twin pack. Booze Brothers, we know booze.
And again, that man Aaron Davies setting up a Demon goal. He is super quick and slick and unselfish.
Now, what a finish from Matthew Bate.
Just his 52.
Sixth game of football. The 19-year-old. What a great effort it was. Fraser gets it down. Tie up in the middle.
Aaron Davey just keeps assisting teammates with handballs and short passes to set goals up. And a couple of the big Collingwood forwards, Steve, they look really sore. They've been crashed to ground several times.
Well, the two drop marks by Tarrant have been critical.
So O'Bree was able to retrieve the Johnson tap on. He handballs to Morrison. Davis kick. Numbers with the Demons. Green. Kick around the body with the non-dominant sides. Okay. Gets the bait. Got Bartram in support if he wants to use him. Well done, O'Bree. Just stalked him. Now Bartram tries to get around Loney and does. Bartram hard up against the line, looking for an option towards the top of the goal square. Meets and Prestigiacomo. The fist from Prestigiacomo. Davey, he's electrified. Brilliant. Superb.
Massive stock clearance this long weekend at Stratco with 20% off hardware, 15% off lawn and garden products, 15% off paint and accessories, and 15% off timber. There's 20% off hand tools, and a further 10% off heating's already red-hot catalog pricing. 3 days only. Hurry in and save at Stratco.
What you need today?
It's massive.
And Mick Malthouse would not be happy with a couple of the tackle attempts by Loney and Morrison.
Unbelievable though, Wolsey. Matthew Bate, 6 matches, he's 19 years of age. Clint Bartram, his 11th match, is 18 years of age. These young kids, Lyndon Dunn, who's only 19, all in their first year of AFL footy, coming on and certainly not passengers. The Demons up and full of running with a combination of experience and youth, and there's the experienced end in Neats. They're full of excitement at the moment. The Magpies on the back foot.
They are on the back foot, and you saw it there with James Clement paddling it through, not prepared to get it and come back. They are really under the pump at the moment, the Magpies. It's Melbourne's opportunity. They need to get a couple more in the next 5 minutes, and it'll be hard to see Collingwood come back.
Fraser coming off. Travis Cloak perhaps having a run in the ruck at the moment. The margin is 22 points. Lucuria. Buckley's pushed wide for him, and he goes shorter than that. You can see Buckley in the top left hand of your screen. Loney for Davis. There's Bartram with him. Full of confidence. Got good back out from Carroll. To Davey. Been involved in so many of their forward thrusts. Again, precision for Green, who was on his wrong side, so has to double back. Magpies getting lots of numbers inside 50.
It's 6 against 2 at the moment, so he'll just sit on the footy.
So he should. This is where they're free, in the middle. Luce, we know he can go. And we know he's got a big hoof on him to full forward. This battle between Clement and Robertson, they both let it go. Astounding goal from Adam Luce. Well, Robertson, I guess, must take the credit there, Sauce.
Well, he does, but just Paul Martin by the Collingwood players, they're all sitting off, putting on a zone inside their back 50, and we always know that, you should know that Uze's a pretty good kick outside 50. Well done by Robinson just to get the shepherd in to allow the goal through.
So a big challenge ahead for Collingwood now. The margin has blown out to 28 points. Jamar gets it down towards Bate. Now Godfrey, kick run down by Rocker. Yakabuchi playing his first game of the season. Sweeps the handball over the top towards O'Bree. Handball now Lucuria. He's got Travis Cloak out wide from just inside 50. He bangs away and kicks it out of the field.
Oh, gee, they haven't come, haven't risen to the occasion at the moment, the Magpies. This will be interesting. Demons are setting up a little bit of a huddle.
That is Shane Wakeland doing a bit of running along the boundary line in front of us. We'll check in with Christy soon to get an update.
No one stood the mark there. Magpies off their game at the moment.
Phil Reid into the team. He's played a role today. Carroll. And they've worked their way out into space. Rivers floating across halfback. Goes for young Chris Johnson. Sure, didn't interfere according to the umpire. Help arrives in the form of the captain. Turnover, Johnson. Davis one out, but it won't get there. Bate taking no chances.
Gee, they are not thinking, this Collingwood team. Anthony Rocker by himself desperately needs a touch, and they've gone over his head to a contest.
Just checking again those matchups. Presta Giacomo on Neats, Morrison on Uze. Lockyer now on Davey. Let's get down to Christy just for an update on Shane Wakeland.
Yeah, he's up and walking around the boundary line at the moment. It is an ankle injury. They've been working tirelessly on it. He's trying to run it out at the moment, but at this stage, he doesn't look close to coming back on.
Kick inside, attacking 50, and they'll get a ball up for the Magpies.
Rob, I'm just wondering whether it's time to give Anthony Arocca a run in the ruck. He hasn't had a possession yet at full forward.
Absolutely, Steve. That's what they need to do. Get the big fella in the ruck, free him up for 5 or 8 minutes, give him a chance to get a touch of the footy.
Rocker down towards Tarrant.
No, both heads are over it.
Holland knocks it out, flicks out towards Bruce to Bate. Sidestep is effective around Ben Johnson. And the Melbourne side away again. Bate, long kick out wide. Preston Giacomo with the sit here. Couldn't quite hold on, but he recovers best. And can kick around the body and find Shaw. So Magpies just controlled things in the last couple of minutes in general play, but haven't got reward on the scoreboard after a blitz from the Demons. Buckley now. Kick towards centre-half forward. It's a dangerous kick. Tarrant needs to mark it. Reid has stood his ground. Strong play. And he'll get the free kick at half-back.
Gutsy effort, Phil Reid. And that's what he's in the team for.
Demons move it out wide. Ward came into the team for Whelan. And Bartram continues to impress. Possession number 8 coming up. It's the run that he's been able to give out of defence. Again, they've been able to find free men too through the middle. Reid. Rivers sneaking down into attack on the right-hand side. They might yet be able to get it across to him. This is Bate. Reid. Oh, adapted the kick beautifully. And there's Rivers.
Well, that's a couple of times this quarter, Rob, where the on-ballers for Collingwood have sat off back in their defensive 50. And we just see Thomas in the background there. And that is an easy set-up shot for Rivers here.
Has not kicked a goal in AFL footy, Jared Rivers. Let's fly. What a time to stand up to the plate.
So Truscott's need to clear stock now. Out goes LG 500-watt home theatre system, just $299. That's $100 off. Acer 81-centimetre LCD TV, just $17.99 after $150 cash back. LG 80-gig hard drive DVD recorder, just $499. That's $50 off. NEC 106-centimetre plasma TV with 3-year warranty, just $22.95. That's $200 off. Have a happy new financial year at Truscott's.
Anthony Rocker. He is in the ruck, Steve, as if on cue. He gets up early, wins it down. Bates been very, very good. Well tackled by the courier and a ball up.
Let him go now, thanks.
He's got so much pace through the midfield now, blokes like Bate.
And there's a shot of Rivers by himself.
And Thomas is a direct opponent, Rob.
So one forward now by Melbourne O'Bree. There's Thomas. Been pretty quiet today, Dale Thomas. Now, not much to go to because his man's back in the hole. So forced to give it to Lockyer. Ben Johnson normally finds a target. Searching one towards Travis. Clogger has taken off the ball. Advantage paid. Penalty can goal from 30. He kicks. And he goals. Is it advantage? No. It's coming back.
Well, that certainly won't please the black and white army.
So, there's the free kick.
Kenning, kick it, Chris. You spend half your life down there at Collingwood at training sessions. Well, I know you work with the defenders, but can this fella make the distance?
Well, he can make the distance. No doubt about that.
You'd rather have a kick from here.
So the umpire just explaining why advantage wasn't paid.
When he looked up, Pendlebury was under pressure, and I think that's why he made the decision to pull it back.
He'll have to kick this 60 metres.
Drop punt on its way. It's a thumping kick. It's offline, is it? No, well done by Jamar, just touching it through. And Collingwood's first score for a little while.
Really makes the Collingwood fans happy too, doesn't it? See that behind go through. Johnston hits Uze in the back pocket. Smart play up the field by the Magpie players because they stay boundary side of all their Melbourne opponents, so nothing to go to. Forced to retreat for the moment. Now Johnston hits a target on the other side. It's a sizable target in Jamar. Fluent work for Bruce. Green under pressure, but he had his wits about him. Oh, Bruce completely surrounded by Magpie jumpers. His second effort was good. Jamar's second effort was good, but there's Magpies galore across half forward. Buckley taking the onus on himself. Feeding for Lockyer. No margin for
that chance. Pushed
over the back. Hunted down by Aaron Davey. And Matthew James was on the spot. Let's see, what's your decision? Well,
I think he got it right, Hutto. Hands are in the back. What else could Aaron Davey have done? That's the question, but if the hands are in the back, you're in trouble.
So once again, Tarkin Lockyer, tight angle, no margin for error. And he makes no error. Well done.
It's the end of financial year, and people who know their numbers know now's the time to buy Toyota.
2.7
litre petrol Hilux 4x2 double cab workmate, just $26,490, we're there. V8 Land Cruiser 100 GXL with alloy wheels and air conditioning, now $56,990.
One.
The number one event from Australia's number one car company. Get in now while Toyota means business.
Neil Danaher.
Yes, and we can see there Lyndon Dunn and his opponent Ryan Loney. Loney playing at that centre-half back spot because Shane Wakeland off with the injured ankle.
So ball back in the centre. Well done by White, getting it down to Johnston, and Melbourne are away. Travis Johnston kicks to the lead of Robertson. Clement. Too strong, just pushed Robertson under the footy. Kick out wide is okay, Rowe. Now Alan Dydek here on a long lead. Ward applying the pressure, play on the call, no free kick there. And at the back, Rivers, plenty of time just to assess his options. A dangerous kick, well done by Pendlebury, just chipping in front of Uze, and a glare back from Adam Uze.
Change. You can see he was coming towards the interchange bench. He pulled up so he wouldn't go through. He pulled up so he wouldn't go. You see that? He's pulled up and the umpire's got it wrong.
Well, interesting decision because he stood right in between the player taking the kick and the man on the mark. So
it was
the 50 was paid. Pendlebury, rocker, couldn't take it. Arms were chopped. Free kick.
Godfrey, dreadfully unlucky, just circumstances, but I reckon common sense should have prevailed with the umpire then.
There's the pull of the arm and the chop of the arm from Ben Holland, so...
You know they can't use common sense, they've got to apply the rules as they are, Rob.
Okay, so common sense is out, Hunter.
Yep.
So, Collingwood just 1-4 from set shots today, and Anthony Rocker, quite incredibly, coming in for his first disposal of the match, 22 minutes in second term. Can he make it count? Close to the line, couple of steps, and he misses to the right.
Nine-3 Melbourne, 4-7 Collingwood.
Aaron Davey in picture. He is just playing more and more in the back half of the Demons than up forward. And part of the reason for that is that his tackling skills are so good, you've got to keep him in the action.
Brett Green, possession 10. And as you can see, the switch is on. Holland's pushed to the outer side. Carroll honours that lead. Tarrant bearing down here. So that was a bit sloppy. Well done by Chris Tarrant. He lost a boot. Uses the only one he's got left on to knock it away. Good mopping up again by Bartram, who's been so impressive. Off to Carroll, and now Rivers. He's got Bruce at half forward. He wants a longer option. Neitz has been quiet for a while, but been good today. Doubling back Robertson. Clements had the edge on him in the air. One-on-one, it was a neutral ball. As it turns out, the support crew was all Collingwood's. And Rowe accepts from Burns. Looks up. Hard work by Cloak on the wing. Rewarded. Dydak. It's one-on-one, it's Bartram and Davis. Davis did all the hard work. Bartram with the points again. Green finds Holland. And the Demons have the release valve, and this time it's Byron Pickett.
Drop marks of Collingwood inside their forward 50 have been crucial.
I reckon the Pies, look at Brad Green saying, settle down, just settle down. I want to keep possession of it. I don't want to kick to a contest. Give me an option. Here I go.
He kicks out wide to Chris Johnson.
Yeah, and they are playing really well to the game plan, which is keep possession. Have it in our possession 60% of the time. Don't let Collingwood get it. And there we see the percentage of play on after a mark. And Melbourne just 37%. And that's because of doing this. Collingwood supporters are going crook. But don't worry about that. Melbourne are in front on the scoreboard. And that's all that matters to them.
So Ward's got it now on centre. Now he's been called to play on. He waits for Pendlebury to come to him, then wobbles it at best towards half forward. Jamar almost, but he was able to gather at ground level. Well done, Pickett. Tried to get it out to Uze, but Buckley in the way for the Magpies. Little kick around the corner, intended for Pendlebury, but had too much on it. So Ward now shares it with McDonald. Ward off a step, high towards half forward. Now at the back, Cameron Bruce, a big chance here. Great mark. They can go into it. They've got a loose player in the goal square. The kick towards Robertson. Well done, Clement. No free kick, Clement. Lockyer, run down. Buckley needs to be strong. He's got to make four.
Free kick.
It's coming back to Lockyer. I'll tell you what, they were lucky, Collingwood, because Jamar was by himself in the goal square. And they didn't see him. So chance for Lockyer now in the back pocket for the Magpies.
Lockyer. Got cloak away through the middle. Carroll is standing about 5 metres in front of Tarrant at half forward. If they can get it down there, it'll be interesting to see what happens. Here's Lockyer. Will he set it up for that battle? No, he goes longer. I don't think he'll quite get to Rocker on the full. It didn't. At ground level, Carroll might just get a free kick now. That was unnecessary. No, not paid.
It's not active leading. Just grab, get it.
Carroll, who's only had 15 goals kicked against him for the year in 10 matches. Burns can't find a way through. The Demons are defending desperately today. Carroll, well done by Johnston. Good body work also from Ward. Davis, and the ball is over and out.
Interesting this matchup. Russell Robertson's just had one touch for the game. Clement's starting to get into it. He's had nine. Maybe Neil Danaher just gets Robbo to get out of the way, which in turn gets Clement out of the action.
You can see the inside 50s there. The Magpies have been inside more times than the Demons. Haven't been able to do much with it. Morrison suddenly confronted Clement. Oh, again, the margin for error. Davey pouncing out wide for Ruse. He's going to look up and see a few Demons playing in front of their man. This is one of them, the dangerous Cameron Bruce. He's a good kick of the footy.
Gee, Aaron Davey, I'd love to see that again. I just thought Collingwood weren't desperate enough. I reckon Collingwood should have got a hand on that ball. Stop the Davey mark. Davey showed far more desperation.
Is this beyond Cameron Bruce? He is a nice kick, but he really wanted to lay it off there, which would give you the indication that he's not that confident. But he shouldn't have had any doubts.
Wife called. Oh, she seems nice.
Fun meets functionality with a new Motorola Razr V3X.
Hello, Moto.
So, quite incredibly, Melbourne, six goals straight from set shots now.
Have a look at that. And that was just an example of Collingwood players not wanting it as much as Aaron Davey.
Six goals straight, Melbourne. Collingwood, 1-5 from set shots. Lockyer. Handball out wide, row, just forced to handball it because he had no one to go to, then follows up. He's outnumbered 3-on-1 here. Numbers win out eventually. Travis Johnston. Little sidestep. Okay, James McDonald, Uze. Davey again. Lockyer pushed him off the ball. Play on to the call. Melbourne fans don't like it. Lockyer mops up to Shaw, who kicks it long to Burns, who marks just back into the wing. A minute 26 left in the half. And Collingwood certainly needs something before the break, you would think.
Sure. For Lockyer. Leading possession winner for the Magpies with 17. Lockyer's left, looking for Tarrant. Realised he was in not the best shape, so was able to double back, but it was all Melbourne back there. Too hard for Tarrant. Pickett for White. Look at the wealth of numbers through the middle. It's going to go to Jamar. Well, it went for Neitz instead, and all the Magpie defenders were able to predict that. The result is a Travis Cloak ball in the middle. And now Fraser ends up with it on the wing. Rode the bump from Bartram to Tarrant. Back to Fraser. Watch out. Byron was coming. Lockyer sets it up for Rocker and Didak, who's been their most dangerous.
Just with the Josh Fraser mark, he should have been held up. Instead of the bump, should have been held up.
So Alan Didak, who we saw last week have a fantastic game without kicking a goal, 18-7 for the year. He's averaged two goals a game against the Demons, and he's already got his two to half-time. That's a much-needed one.
Good work there initially by Travis Cloke, who was able to spot up the option of Josh Fraser because he had nothing on the wing and had to pull it back inside. The kick was good enough and good play from Fraser just to keep the game moving, as you mentioned, Rob. And a good finish there from Alan Dydak, who has kicked two goals in this second quarter and has brought Collingwood back to within 26 points.
And again, Jared Rivers, the extra man in defence. You can see Dale Thomas saying, well, pretty hard for me to cover two. And Rivers has just played that role perfectly. Mick Maltese can't allow that to continue in the second half.
So out of the centre, James McDonald, but no time. Half-time here at the MCG, the Queen's birthday, big game, and a great performance by Melbourne in this opening half.
Well, they dominated, and they continued on from a very good first quarter. Nathan Carroll doing a fantastic job back in defence, but they've got control of the ball through the middle. Their forwards are presenting well. They've been sparked by Aaron Davey up in the forward line, so they'd be very happy with that first half of football.
They would indeed. A 6-3 quarter for the Demons. You can see the scoreline. It's 10-3 to 5-7. Hope you're enjoying public holiday footy at the G.
Rove's on the case.
Chris Isaac was telling me he found a cap.
That's my hat.
I brought it down to the front desk. They've got your cap.
I'm going to call the front desk.
What happened? And nobody gave it back to her.
I might just have to come down there and straighten this out.
This just in, Jennifer Aniston's cap has been found.
Thank you.
Rove, Tuesday. So Truscott's need to clear stuff now. Out goes LG 500-watt home theatre system, just $299. That's $100 off. Acer 81-centimetre LCD TV, just $17.99 after $150 cash back. LG 80-gig hard drive DVD recorder, just $499. That's $50 off. NEC 106-centimetre plasma TV with 3-year warranty, just $22.95. That's $200 off. Have a happy new financial year at Truscott's.
Fisherman's friend, strongest there is. Fisherman's friend, fresh mint, freshest there is.
Rebel Sport, your World Cup destination.
We're for the ruck, the rover, the full forward, and the fullback. At Pedigree, we're for footy. And together with NAB AFL Auskick, you could be the Pedigree Natural Footy Star. You'll have the chance to attend the 2006 Toyota AFL Grand Final, play on the MCG at halftime, and much more. Visit aflauskick.com.au to see how you could win.
The AFL with Big Pond on your 3G mobile.
When we first spoke on the phone, she was warm, friendly, she laughed at my jokes. It was a beautiful thing. We got along like a house on fire. Until.
And until what?
Until the house caught on fire. And I rang her to make an insurance claim. Hello? Trust? Whatever happened to trust? Trust, trust, trust!
Toyota and RPM are giving you the chance to win the ultimate Formula One experience. VIP passes to the German Grand Prix. Plus, you get to drive a Formula One car, all valued at nearly $50,000. Log on to rpmlive.tv now to enter.
The things we do, Roving Manus, why the hell are we dressed like this?
I have no idea.
Find out on Rogue Sydney Special, Tuesday.
You've got a flight, though.
The 2006 Toyota AFL Premiership season. Proudly brought to you by our broadcast partners. Toyota. Footy. Oh, what a feeling. Harvey Norman. There's a store near you.
Carlton Draft, the beer behind footy. And Pedigree, we're for dogs.
Well, there's been plenty happening at the MCG at halftime. This is an interesting moment. Godfrey running to go off the ground. That was given 50. He didn't stop in time, Wolsey. You thought it was a bad decision.
I thought the umpires, by the letter of the law, got it right, but common sense. He was going off the ground, realised he was in a tough situation. Simon Godfrey backpedaled, but the umpires pinged him anyway.
Anyway, Melbourne supporters wouldn't be too concerned. Look at that scoreboard. 10-3-63 to 5-7-37 at halftime. Davey and Pickett have been brilliant. Two goals also to Nate's. Didak, the lone hand, really up forward for the Magpies. We'll pause on this game for the moment. The boys will have a look at more of it in a moment. But let's turn our attention to the round, because we're getting to the halfway stage of the year, and it's been a fantastic round of footy again. Start way back on Friday night where some of the issues. Cameron Mooney is a key forward. You wanted to talk about this because obviously Geelong's forward line has been their Achilles heel.
Look, I saw him virtually win the NAB Cup for them pre-season, kicked three or four goals in the final quarter. He's just a good presence on the ground. He's able to take contested mark. He's able to cause spills. And we saw there he's pretty good at ground level too. And he just straightens them up. And terrific work there to bring it to ground. I just think that they need Cameron Mooney playing at that centre-half forward position.
Well, they certainly need something. Cats had a win on Friday night. Now, what about the Kangaroos? You saw them Saturday at the MCG?
I did, and I was pretty disappointed with them, Hutto. I just feel that they're not playing with too much spark at all. Some of their skills were terrible. You know, just have a look at that there. Drew Petrie, just sort of a lazy old pack at the football, and it in a defensive spot, and just hands it over to the Tigers. Some of their midfield players, Shannon Grant and Brent Harvey, they are playing as if they're not enjoying their football. And you've got to feel for a bloke like Glenn Archer, who just gives 100% every time he steps out on the ground. I also think that Daniel Wells, he looks as if it's all getting a bit too hard for him at the moment. So they've got their worries, the Kangaroos.
And that is live footage from here today. John Longmire and Paul Roos watching on this game. On the weekend, they were coaching against the Saints, and they finally put a big ruckman in the St Kilda lineup, big Michael Ricks, and what a start he made in the first couple of minutes.
Have a look at the size of him. He's a big fella, and he was able to get a goal with his first kick in league football. There he is there, the big fella. And on the boundary line, wet conditions, he put it through, but for a first time in a long time, Hutto, the Saints won the hit-outs. And I think they need to have that big fella in their side. I thought the Saints were great on Saturday night because the conditions were wet and you needed a lot of courage, and they put their bodies on the line, and nobody better than Nick Riewoldt, who ran back and took a few marks that you just held your breath. So brave were they.
What about Matt Maguire? Had a chance to square up, I guess, a bit some of the angst that have come his way since last year when Barry Hall went to the tribunal and of course was cleared of striking, or he wasn't cleared, but he didn't get any weeks anyway of striking against Maguire.
Well, I thought Matty Maguire was fantastic. He plays with plenty of courage too, and he owed Barry Hall one, there was no doubt about that, and in the build-up to the week he was really keen to make sure that he put in a good one. He did. He took the honours, and Big Barry, he really struggled.
What about your boys, Wolsey, the Blues?
Well,
what an escape from the Eagles. They've done it again.
Good signs, though, Hutto, and they're starting to play some of those kids, and I think they've got to keep doing that, blokes like Kennedy and Russell. Now, the West Coast Eagles, they've done it 2 weeks in a row. They've come back from big margins down, 54 points against the Cats. I think they were 44 points down during the third quarter against the Blues, and they were able to get up and win. Now, you don't want to make a habit of that because it won't happen all the time, but I thought for Carlton there were very good signs to go over there and do what they did.
And there's Daniel Chick involved in Embley. Didn't he stand up as the fill-in captain? Amazing finish with the Eagles. Poor old Dennis Pagan left pondering about what it could have been, and the crowd, of course, are going nuts. Well, last thoughts for you at halftime on the Magpies. How are they feeling in the Roos? Because they played very poorly. Are they still a chance?
Oh, they're a chance. And the reason they're a chance, I don't think they could have played much worse than what they did in that first half. And Melbourne, on the other hand, played exceptionally well. And you'd expect players like Tarrant and Rocker to have better second half. So too Nathan Buckley. And I reckon Mick Malthouse will change a little bit of his coaching, because you can't allow Rivers to have that loose man roll across halfback, which he did. And that set up so many demon thrusts. Melbourne were terrific, though. They like it in close. If it becomes an arm wrestle and really close, and they need to win the contest in at the boundary throw-ins and centre bounce as well, look out, because the Demons are very, very strong there.
Gee, I'm so impressed with Melbourne and their kids. I mentioned during the call, three kids who are in their first season of AFL footy, less than 10 games, and they're just having an impact.
Yes, a lot of them had a year at Melbourne last
year. Yes, they did.
Playing in the seconds.
Yep.
Terrific development coach down there in Chris Fogan.
All right, we'll take a break from the MCG. Plenty more to come at the moment. It's the Demons holding sway.
Just when you thought it was safe to put on a few kilos for winter,
Bob and Jillian are back and tougher than ever.
Strong, aren't you?
7:30 Wednesday.
Witness two families go gut to gut in one hefty battle of the bulge.
This is more than looking good in a pair of pants. It's life and death.
In a massive two-hour special, you will see a complete transformation.
I just got chills.
The Biggest Loser Special Edition, 7:30 Wednesday on 10.
It's a big night, very big night. It's a big night we're in. It's a big night. My God, it's big. Can't believe how big.
Whiskers VitaBites, now with Dental Protection Plus. Cats know the difference.
Hi.
Cappuccino, please.
Cafe. Now there's a thought.
You wouldn't believe some of the places I've seen through work. London, Singapore, Beijing, Hong Kong, and now Coca-Cola here in Canada. The CPA qualification is recognised around the world. It's given me the ability to go in and talk with colleagues around the world on an equal footing and a respected footing. Okay, so I still do a little bit of number crunching occasionally.
These guys look like they need a bit of a lift to keep them going, so I've prepared a little something with a few things I found around the place. So we've got some prawns on the go in here.
Where'd that bait get to, Pete? Put out in the sun to thaw out yesterday. Oh.
Actually, the best way to fill blokes up is with a bit of this. Let's just let go of that.
Campbell's, the experts in soup.
Mmm. That is, you know, good. Just don't touch that. How's the fishing? Still nothing?
Yes, welcome back to the MCG. Half-time in the Big Queen's birthday clash between Melbourne and Collingwood. And it's all Melbourne. They're doing it very well at half-time. They lead by 26 points. They led by 9 at quarter-time. And, Steve, they started very, very well, the Demons, but they continued in the second quarter. But let's take a look at some early highlights in this first quarter. This was the opening goal of the match to Leon Davis, and that was a moment of brilliance. But really, after that, it was Collingwood making a number of mistakes and Melbourne really dropping into the game.
Well, they did. It was their handling errors, their kicking errors, and it's paid off for Melbourne's pressure. Melbourne have been able to get them on the rebound and really make Collingwood pay where their errors have come into play. And look, their pressure's been pretty good, Melbourne, and this is one of the few times that Collingwood's able to capitalise. A great goal there by Chris Tarrant. Good little tackle by Thomas, but it's been the run by the Demons and their work off the ball that's really been sensational.
Yes, one of the players, Byron Pickett, involved in that passage of play, the kick to Robertson, and Byron Pickett, 10 possessions for the first half, four marks. He, along with Aaron Davey, have really given them some great speed and some excitement through the midfield. And what a chase down, talking about Aaron Davey. That was just before quarter time. Really great run down and resulted in the goal.
Yeah, and look, he's been the highlight of the first half, I think, Aaron Davey. The amount of assists he's given to his players and goals that he's set up has been sensational. He's got wonderful speed, wonderful work ethic at the ball, and we've just seen part of that just then. But one of the few players that can hold his head up high for the Collingwood is Alan Dyer, kicking two goals in that first half. He's probably the only forward that is actually on top at the minute.
Yes, and there's another unfortunate slip there from Chris Tarrant. And what about this goal from Matthew Bate? Just 19 years of age and just his sixth game of AFL football. It's these young Melbourne players that have really turned it on, and there's some magic there from Aaron Davey. Really, Melbourne have taken all before them.
Well, Bate and Bartram and Dunn have been fantastic. Of course, in front of a huge crowd, they've been able to maintain their composure in a high-pressure game. Uze, well, we just see that goal there. What a superb player he's been.
Now, what can Collingwood do in their second half to try and get back into it?
I think they've just got to eliminate their skill errors. It's really hurt them.
That's the key thing. Back shortly at the MCG for the second half. Melbourne by 26.
Good afternoon. Tonight in 10 News, business groups up in arms over Kim Beazley's pledge to scrap workplace agreements as unions step up the campaign with a fresh wave of ads. Some special South Australians among those to receive Queen's birthday honours, and bookies declare the Socceroos favourites as thousands of Aussie fans descend on Germany for tonight's clash with Japan.
The Stratco Outback, a place to relax and enjoy your own backyard or entertain family and friends. As a stylish and affordable addition, the Stratco Outback Veranda Patio will improve the look and value of your home. So, for a complete lifestyle solution designed to your individual needs, contact Stratco or an authorised veranda patio dealer and start enjoying life outback. What you need today?
These guys look like they need a bit of a lift to keep them going, so I've prepared a little something with a few things I found around the place. So we've got some prawns on the go in here.
Where'd that bait get to, Pete? Put down the sun to thaw out yesterday. Oh.
Actually, the best way to fill blokes up is with a bit of this. Just let go of that.
Campbell's, the experts in soup.
Mmm, that is, you know, good. Just don't touch that. How's the fishing? Still nothing?
Rebel Sport, your World Cup destination.
I've always tried to give back to my fans, so I'm on the home phone a lot.
Yeah, you wrote to me in 1975.
By switching to Primus Home Cap, I've saved more than $50 a month.
Beverly? Madeline? Yes, yeah, Susie, it's Leo Sayer.
Changing was easy. I just called Primus and they helped me select the best plan.
The singer, you know.
With Primus's everyday low rates, I can make loads more calls.
Yeah. You gotta go.
Call 1300 Primus now and find out how much you can save.
That's more like it.
How lucky can you get, eh? Beautiful wife, perfect place for a honeymoon. This calls for a drink. Here's to us.
There are some things you just wouldn't miss, like Territory SR rear-wheel drive from only $39,490 with over $3,800 worth of special extras. There's cruise control, 17-inch alloys and running boards, plus a leather sports steering wheel and sports shifter, but only for a limited time at participating Ford dealers.
Fisherman's friend. Strongest there is. Fisherman's friend. Fresh mint. Freshest there is.
The 2006 Toyota AFL Premiership season. Proudly brought to you by our broadcast partners. Toyota. Footy. Oh, what a feeling. Bundaberg Rum. Classic. And Bunnings Warehouse, where lowest prices are just the beginning.
Here are the
nomination for the Toyota Goal of the Week in Round 10. Fremantle's Peter Bell threads the eye of a needle. A bit of fancy footwork by Adelaide's Trent Henshaw. And some great attacking play by Bulldog youngster Ryan Griffin.
Cranbourne Hawkins win. Griffin takes on Bateman by foot. Did it well. Runs to 50, Griffin. Can he lift them out of the mire? Oh, that's a good goal.
Time now to announce the winner of the Goal of the Week for Round 10 for the Toyota Goal of the Year, and it was a very tight one. Ryan Griffin actually got most of the public vote, but Peter Bell got the most of the experts' tip and most for the overall vote. So well done to Peter Bell for the Round 10 Goal of the Week. Now, just an injury update here at the MCG, where Melbourne leads Collingwood by 26 points. Shane Wakeland came off the ground during that term with not an ankle injury. He actually has a corked calf right down the bottom of the calf, right down near the ankle. He had a lot of treatment on it, had no ice applied. During the halftime break, he was running around the change rooms trying to keep moving. He does want to come back on the ground in the second half, but they will have to see how that injury progresses. And for Melbourne, Phil Reid has a corked quad. He too, he's actually out on the ground now, not strapped up. He is another tough one who wants to play in the second half. He looks like perhaps he's more of a chance than Shane Wakeland at this stage.
Thank you, Christy. Yeah, Phil Reid, 9 possessions and 4 inside 50s in the first 20 minutes of that third quarter. A couple of other things to keep in mind. The Magpies are the third quarter specialists this year. They won 9 out of 10 third quarters, outscoring the opposition by a total of 229 points, so over 20 points a quarter. And the other thing is that last week Melbourne led St Kilda by 36 points at halftime and only won by 13. So I reckon that'll be in their mind, boys. They have to make sure they keep attacking because they went a bit defensive last week.
And that's an interesting one. Travis Cloak lined up at centre half back on Dunn.
Second half from the MCG, the Demons by 26 points.
Bounce favours Fraser, who taps to himself, then hoists it high towards half forward. Tarrant coming to meet it. Ball pitching just in front. Loney can't control it. Reid, or he's taken front on there from Tarrant, and he'll get the free kick. So Phil Reid called to play on, so concedes ground back to Travis Johnston. Good pressure coming from Chris Tarrant. Caused a turnover, no, he has it. Holland, little left foot kick. Royal Bartram a little unsure there. Now Jeff White just to mop up to Uze. Kick around the body towards the wing. Fraser, little fumble. Was carried forward in the tackle by Davey. No free kick. Well, the Curry put his head down, he's hurt. Bate gave it somehow to Travis Johnston. Towards half forward. Dunn in front of Travis Cloak. Out comes Robertson. Good pressure from Clement. Oh, great tackle from James Clement. Davey just lost the handle. Oh, Drew needed a shepherd there for Morrison. Didn't. Allows Melbourne back in through Bruce. He ties it up. So we'll get a bounce just outside 54. The Demons.
And Rob, Nathan Buckley's starting at full forward for the Magpies.
Yes, and a shot there of Shane Wakeman. He doesn't look too good.
Not going anywhere, I don't think, at the moment, is he? Torrid start in the first minute or so of this third quarter. Clean possessions have been very rare. And again, just missing targets slightly. The Demons. Johnston delayed his kick. Tried to find Neats. You can see the desperate lunge. Lockyer just banged away. It was hitting hope stuff. And again, decision-making not great, this time from Bartram, but he gets a second chance and he makes the most of it. Ward, Davis gave him a bit to go on with Reid. Low to the ground player, very solid. Green was clapping as he made a leap through the middle of your screen there.
Uze pleading for him to kick it long.
Neats has got to come over the top of Cloak. He couldn't do that. He is done. Goes to work. Left foot. He's trying to get it to come back.
Lyndon Dunn only had a couple of touches in that first half. Big risk by Mick Malthouse to put Travis Cloak back there. Cloak spent most of the season playing up forward.
I think it's a position he's got to learn to play, though, Rob. Travis Cloak, big enough to play in that position and mobile.
Collingwood work it out to Ben Johnson at halfback. Kick OK to Loney.
Stay there, Jaron!
Ryan Loney between halfback and wing. That's what's ahead of him. Fairly vacant wing position. He sure makes a move, but he instead kicks shorter to Lecuria. Back to Loney. Needs to be precise with this possession, and he is. Lockyer Loney kept going. Third possession in this transition. Poor one. Mark taken by Ward. So Melbourne on the rebound here. Handball off to Bartram. Bruce, they're moving it well. Robertson between half forward and wing. Got loose player outside. Bruce, now Uzo's running for him. He elects not to give it to him and drives it long to a vacant goal square. Cameron Bruce offline, one behind. So the Melbourne build-ups are very exciting. They're looking very dangerous at the Melbourne, and the Magpies can ill afford Melbourne to kick some early goals in this third term.
And again, nothing clean. And Burns has got issues here in the back pocket. Lucuria have kept it moving. All of a sudden, it comes to a grinding halt. Great tackling by the Demons. And clever by McDonald, too. Johnston went to ground. Green, Johnson, Reed, as angry as ever. McDonald in there. Tough to get out for bait, but he found a way. Green got some treatment. High to full forward, almost for Neats, tackling his teammate and opposition at once.
If this game becomes in close contest, I think the Demons are going to be too good for the Magpies. Magpies all season have liked the open, free-flowing football.
Done. Davey. Bang. Goal. Goal.
Ten's brand new comedy hour starts with a shock.
Your dad might not be your dad.
So who is Homer's real father? Brand new Simpsons, 7:30 Tuesday. Then at 8 o'clock on 10's new comedy hit The Wedge, these are just some of the wedgies Australia can't get enough of.
No, I'm gonna go, kids, I'm gone.
New Simpsons and The Wedge from 7:30 Tuesday.
So margin back out to 34 points, biggest of the match. Inside 50 so far this quarter, 4-0. O'Bree, Didak, Lucuria, left foot kick, floats it towards Rocker, Tarrant, back to Rocker. They're under constant pressure though, Collingwood. Good tackle from Reed. Ball spills out wide. Rowe, 55 from goal. Can he spot up a target? Davis. Oh!
Set himself for it, came over the top. Gee, he was up high. Want to see this one again.
Oh,
landed on his head.
Oh, that's a contender for mark of the round and mark of the year. So Leon Davis, the chance here for the quick reply for the Magpies. Kicked the opening goal of the match. For just five possessions for the game. A chance here from just 25 metres for goal number two. Four goals won from set shots this year. Leon Davis, drop punt is a goal.
Norman's ripping back prices in our big half-yearly clearance. Buy now and save with 19 months, no deposit, no interest, no repayments till January 2008. Electrical, computers, furniture and bedding. We are ripping back prices to clear the lot. Huge reductions on overstocks and run-out lines with 19 months, no deposit, no interest, no repayments till January 2008. What a deal. Massive savings and 19 months interest-free. Rip into Harvey Norman's big half-yearly clearance and save on now.
And that's a shot of Aaron Davey, again going round to the half-back area for the centre bouncers. Melbourne loading their defence.
White came full of steam with the tap down. There's Rowe in there, number nine for the Magpies. Green lends a hand, McDonald bait, and it's in good hands. Johnston, look at him back his pace. And his foot skills weren't bad. Neats. Presta Giacomo just permanently attached to him this afternoon.
What do you think, Sos? So you've got Davey, spare man in defence. Lockyer, his opponent, who's got the footy now, is the spare man in defence for Collingwood. I don't think Collingwood
don't like
can
it.
Afford that.
No, I just reckon when Davey's a loose player, he sparks the Demons and he carries the footy very well.
So Collingwood work it out this time with better efficiency. Lucuria gets it from Chaw. Paul Lucuria kicks along the southern side. Tarrant in front of Bruce gets a free kick for a hole. To the Collingwood fans.
No.
The There's the hole, the sleeper hole, as he kicks it long to the goal square. Rocker Fraser.
Just a beautiful bit of early body work to take Jeff White under the football. And wonder, well done to Josh Fraser. We'll have a look at the kick here. It's a hard low drop punt. Just a little bit of early body work, and Jeff White disappointing in that contest.
First time a tall forward for Collingwood's taken a mark inside their forward 50.
6-9 from set shots this year, Josh Fraser. From 30 metres, drop punt. This time's a goal.
You know what I love about Subway restaurants? Same thing you do. Great tasting food and lots of it. They've got tons of choices, so you can get something different every day. I'm gonna go check out what deal they have today. Now this is a deal worth walking all the way across town for.
The $3.50 daily special. Every day a different delicious, great tasting 6-inch Subway sub on fresh baked bread, fresh toasted and made the way you like it for just $3.50. 7 days, 7 great 6-inch subs, all for the one daily special price of just $3.50.
Subway, eat fresh.
Well, there we see Josh Fraser. I think he's given his opponent, Jeff White, the send-off. Well, that's OK, Josh, but have a look at the scoreboard.
Push him in.
You get in trouble for that in cricket if you've got the batsman out. 23 points the difference. Bit of jumper hanging on there. Loney didn't get the free. It's on the wing. Bartram and Davis. Suddenly a bit of adrenaline and a bit of momentum with the Magpies. They've kicked the last two. The Demons won't want to try and shut up shop. Last week they led at halftime convincingly and the Saints almost got back in it. White has a rest. Fraser and Jamar do battle. Here's Davey, so creative. Put the brakes on at the right time because he saw them lining up through the middle. Green now on the left. The arc set up for Neitz. Wasn't good positioning. Prestigiacomo at the back. Got his teammates around him. There it is. Good backup crew, Clement.
Pickett. Interesting matchup this, Steve. Cameron Bruce spending a lot of time playing on Tarrant. I reckon Tarrant would hate that.
Yeah, there's been a few rotations go through that back half for Melbourne.
Yeah, Tarrant wouldn't like having a player who's creative and's prepared to run off him.
Well, I guess if they get the ball in there, though, Rob, I mean, he might fancy his chances against Bruce. I think the reason it's happened, Soss, is Buckley's gone back to the goal square at full forward, which means that Carroll's gone to Buckley. But meantime, the action's at the other end, and here's Bate. Kicked a goal earlier from here. Had to use the hands this time. Johnston's left was as good as his right. And Uzay accepted the pass.
Just uses the ball so well, Travis Johnston. And Uzay knew all the time that he was going to centre this.
Gee, it's a good kick.
Five kicks this quarter for Johnston. I mentioned earlier, Uzay kicked five goals in this match last year. And here he is sending through a crucial one for the Demons to steady the ship.
Some brothers are famous for their driving prowess. We're famous for great booze prices. Like Crown Lager, just $43.99 a carton. Choose any two bottles of Ballantine Scotch Whiskey, Smirnoff Vodka, Cougar Bourbon or St. Agnes 5-year-old VSOP Brandy for only $50. Or Berry 5-litre casks, just $18 a twin pack. Booze Brothers, we know booze.
So, Josh Fraser, mate Mark Jamar, so Fraser's got to do it against the couple this afternoon. Jamar fists it forward towards Dunn, little fumble. They've got back up though. Green thumps it back inside, attacking 50. Out comes Robertson, little push from Clement. Play on to the call, the courier. Rowe gets around Davey and Loney's free on the wing. Now Travis Cloak. Tarrant leads for him. Ball pitches in front of him, needs support. Searching handball, Bate read it superbly. Off to Godfrey. Now there's loose players for Melbourne on the rebound. Robertson.
Ooh.
Off a step, kicks towards Pickett, who just read it better. So he'll kick from 50 to extend the Melbourne lead.
No, I just think Mick Malthouse has to get Nathan Buckley into the game, Rob. He's standing there at full forward. He hasn't seen much of the play in this quarter. They need some type of spark in the midfield.
Absolutely, Steve. It's just starting to get away.
I'd almost put... I think you'd put Tarrant at full forward, open up the forward line. One of the weaknesses for Melbourne is their defence, their leg speed.
Truscott's need to clear stock now. Out goes LG 500-watt home theatre system, just $299. That's $100 off. Acer 81-centimetre LCD TV, just $17.99 after $150 cash back. LG 80-gig hard drive DVD recorder, just $499. That's $50 off. NEC 106-centimetre plasma TV with three-year warranty, just $22.95. That's $200 off. Have a happy new financial year at Truscott's.
And there's Nathan Buckley. Steve Silvani says he should be in the middle. I think he should be too.
It's only been inside there twice this quarter, Rob. Nine times for Melbourne. Here they go again. Bate and Jamar. Averages four disposals a game. Jamar, but providing good backup for Jeff White. Travis Johnston's been the architect of plenty. Didn't get a free. The Melbourne fans thought he might have deserved. Shaw, Morrison.
That is terrible play by Chad Morrison. He's got no composure in that back line at all.
Here's Bate. We saw him kick a long one earlier. Sets it up for the high flyers. Oh, Robertson is the ultimate high flyer. Byron Pickett misses.
Does he love the occasion, Byron? Well, give me a grand final. Give me a full MCG and I'll turn it on. The Norm Smith medalist.
So Melbourne now by an even six goals as Clement finds Shaw in the back pocket. Johnson, who plays on, searching kick towards Tarrant. It's got to beat Bruce. Bruce does well to fist it towards the line. Travis Johnston inspiring in this third term. Bruce, oh, he threw it away there. Oh, no, paid a handball. Great tackle from Travis Clayton. Play on advantage. Green drives it towards Neitz. Couldn't hold on. Took out Shaw with him. Done. Little fumble there from Godfrey. Allows Lockyer in just to kick it away from the danger zone. Iacobucci. We've got Fraser wide if he wants him. Decides to go instead to row. So the two first gamers this year towards full forward.
Had to use Jamar Fraser
in the way.
Rowe had to use Fraser. Jamar was a loose man. Fraser all on his own.
Ward the sweeper. Gets good protection. Bruce gives it back to him. And still they come. The end delivery wasn't too good, but again, good teamwork around Godfrey, allowed him to get out of it unharmed. Bruce, hard ball for Neitz to control. Once again, his shadow is there, Prestigiacomo. Travis Johnston going where the ball is to Godfrey. Uze into the pocket, Robertson and Clement. You back Clement here in what we've seen today.
Oh, good test goal.
He's too good in those one-on-one situations. Robertson's got to get on the bike. Out wide, Burns. Here's Big Jamar, though. The ball just falling for the Demons at the moment. They've got the run, they've got the feel, they've got the footy. Done. Just about within range. Tolbo's teammates to have a shot.
Well, Cameron Bruce is running off Tarrant. Buckley's freezing at full forward. I reckon maybe Tarrant goes to full forward. That gets Cameron Bruce out of the action. Push Buckley up into the midfield. Get the skipper into the play, because Nathan Buckley hasn't had a disposal in the last 17 minutes.
Lyndon Dunn, 19-year-old, seven goals for the season, kicked a goal in every match so far this year that he's played for the Demons. At least one goal. So far today, he hasn't. Now he has!
Right, money, we're off. We'll see you at the party.
Yeah, no worries, fellas.
Bye.
I'll see you there. Clever, fellas. Very clever.
I like a bloke who's man enough to wear pink. Come meet my friends.
Sure. Cheers for the fashion tip, fellas. Classic.
So some real concerns now for the Magpies. The margin is out to 42 points. Mark Jamar playing a very good last 5 minutes. O'Brien, death tap towards Fraser, who just handballs towards Davis. Well done by Loney. Can he pick a loose football up? No. Rivers shovels it to Green. Bartram, well done. Bruce, kick around the body towards the wing. Dunn versus Travis Cloak. Well done by Travis Cloak. Got that out of the way. Now can he use it effectively? He can. Burns has made position. So the Magpies now. Burns kicks it long. 3-on-3 contest. Ball to Thomas. Thomas 40 from goal. Buckley chips it out wide. Shaw. Shaw's got support out wide through Chad Morrison, who chips it into the pocket. Missed the target.
No, it's just not good enough.
Tarrant gathers the ball. Had nowhere to go. And Melbourne are able to bring it out through Pickett. Pickett up into the corridor. And they're away, the Demons. Mark taken by Green.
Gill.
And space to work in again, Bruce. Huzay needs trying to work his way clear. Instead, it goes for Robertson. That's been one battle. It's gone the Magpies' way. Here's Davey. Back for Johnson. Young Chris Johnson on the left. Couple of big mistakes there. Pendlebury over the top. Shaw. Davey off the ground. Is there anything he can't do? Cloak with a few worries on his hands. So close to goal. Meets this way, that away. The Demons are staying in town.
Well, unbelievable football by the Demons. Just bad handling by the Magpies. They just double-handed. Nothing clean about what they're doing at the minute. But great pressure by the Demons. Great finish by David Meats.
And again, Aaron Davey kept the ball alive. Aaron Davey with that soccer off the ground. Nathan Buckley continues to stay in the goal square.
So Fraser doing battle. White back on the ground decisively. Davis was dragged off the footage. And there's free kick coming Collingwood's way.
Should give a bit of credit to Ben Holland too, boys. I mean, he's reinvented himself here as a gorilla keeper, hasn't he, really? Playing on the big blokes, as Dennis Pagan used to call him.
He's done it very well.
Davis chips it short. And Tarrant marks on attacking 50. So the margin now add to 8 goals, incredibly. There's Buckley and Carroll.
I'll give you some hope, Chriso. Remember what the Eagles did yesterday.
So Tarrant from outside 50. It's a wonderful effort. It's just offline. He got the distance without any trouble at all, but just the one behind to Chris Tarrant. So Melbourne with an opportunity to bring it back in. Ben Holland didn't want to kick it.
No, and Aaron Davey says, well, I'll do everything. I'll kick goals, I'll set them up, I'll be a midfielder, and I'll even do the kicking in for you.
They're not playing against Carlton, though, Wolsey, or Geelong, for that matter. Holland along the boundary line for Bates. Paid the mark. Well, either had to be a free kick. Or play on, surely.
This young fellow with the footy has had 7 handballs in this third quarter alone.
I think that was a mark. Anyway, Bate takes it to half forward. Rivers and Loney and Clement and Robertson and Bell and Holland. Full of confidence now. Neats. And then the ground fleet. And there's Buckley back in the thick of it. Beautiful kick. Some penetration through the middle. Lockyer being stalked by Pickett. Now Didex left Ward on the ground. Can he get back onto the left? Great play.
Geez, a smart player, Didex.
Didn't panic, did he?
No, he just has a great awareness of what's happening. Doesn't rush himself. And fast establishing a reputation as one of the A-grade players in the competition.
I think one of the things that's really improved with his game this year has been his work rate, Rob. Alan Didak.
Got himself really fit.
Here's Pendlebury then. Kicked a goal from a similar distance last week with his first kick. And he's nailed this one as well.
When Judgment Day comes, will Superman save us?
It's big screen action.
It's Blockbuster Special Effects. Where do you go when you want the Man of Steel?
The biggest Superman action is not just in cinemas.
It's right here on a brand new Smallville, 7:30 Thursday.
So there's a look at the dominance, particularly in this third quarter by the Demons. Fraser, shark by Travis Johnston, long towards the goal square. Presta Giacomo, not quite. Chance for Neitz. He's got Uze free. Oh, no!
They will not lose today, Michael.
You wouldn't think so after that, would you?
When things like that happen, you can't lose.
You can't lose, Chriso. They're all good positive signs, aren't they, for Melbourne? And the centre break was an absolute beauty. Travis Johnston.
It's been a big workload for Josh Fraser. 13 possessions and one goal won. But the Demons are just getting it out of the middle. And they're drilling the ball forward. James McDonald gets in on the act this time.
Simon, your kick, Simon. You are next to the post, your closest man.
The umpire forcing Simon Prestigiacomo to take his third kick of the day.
Play on. Sorry. Yards.
And a bit of a helicopter job for Johnson. Green not letting him get away easily. Uze putting his body on the line. Thomas escapes. Using Morrison out the back.
Fair.
Sets it up for a one-on-one. White will be keen to spoil Fraser. Here's Johnson. Davis doing the business. Made it tough for Tarrant there.
Gee, this is a good coaching move by Neil Danaher. Oh. Cameron Bruce to be able to play at centre-half back. And Neil Danaher has been criticised in the past for being a staid, conservative coach. He certainly sprung a few changes today, and they've all worked. Well done to the Demon coach.
Ben Holland now. Up with Rocker on the wing. The Demons 103, the Magpies 56. Not the greatest looking kick in the world. Godfrey just about have to pay that, not quite. Johnston. Plenty of Magpie socks around in his vision. And he's only got a ball up there. You were waving your arms around, Michael.
Young Dale Thomas there, little fellow with the long hair. I reckon he needs a spell back in the twos. He's done very well to have played 10 of the 11 games in his first season, but he's pretty skinny and he needs to have a good rest and a good feed.
Well done by Bell. Oh, knocks it inside, attacking 50. Morrison missed it initially, went back to get it, but couldn't get it away effectively. Chris Johnson, now big job here for Heath Shorbit. Didak in from the side, takes a spectacular mark. So getting back to help the defence now, Didak. But you just look up the ground, that the run that's been there all year for the Magpies just is not there at the moment, although Chris Tarrant on a long lead is able to accept the Didak mark. Smother from Bruce. He's got support there from Loney. But he's got support in turn from Morrison. Now Lockyer. Morrison sweeps a dubious-looking handball to Iacobucci, who's surrounded by three Demons. Ward, brilliantly done by Pemmelry. Chopped it off initially, but McDonald found it back. And now there, forward again, Reed. Advantage played as Bruce kicks to half forward. Thomas couldn't get there. Travis Johnston, what a quarter he's had.
What a great game, Travis Johnston.
So he's been outstanding in this quarter, Travis Johnston. 9 possessions in this third term. He has really set the game alight for the Demons. From 60, drives it to the goal square. Uze and clever. Uze!
Thomas, who was his opponent, that's yes. Why he went for Uze.
Yes, and that's right. Look, Dale Thomas is a boy playing a man's game at the moment. He could have got a fist on that one there. And we'll have a look at this one coming down. And Clement had to come in to help out. Not Clement's fault.
212 consecutive games. He kicks another.
It was the Tasmanian drought of 1842. Concerned that without any water, the Cascade Brewery would run dry, founder Peter de Graves had the idea to divert the town's pure river water to supply the brewery. Although they had no water for bathing, cleaning, or drinking, the town celebrated because Cascade had a bumper yield of beer. So thank you, Peter de Graves. You knew what was important to the people. Beer. That's the Cascade way.
Both teams, sorry, Rob.
Just have a look at that, Hutto. Cameron Bruce has now decided, well, I'll go forward and make it even harder for the Magpie defence.
Thank you.
Carroll's gone on to Tarrant.
Buckley obviously not on the forward line anymore.
No, well, it's a bit late now for Buckley to go into the midfield.
Looks like Buckley's actually gone into defence as Cloak tries to poke this one for Burns. Magpies today, of course, without Swan and Holland, who have been, and young Maxwell as well, who have been important players for them. Obviously, the Demons missing McLean, Miller and Whelan, amongst others.
I think the other big omission from Collingwood side has been Guy Richards.
Burns lets fly, and I reckon that's home.
Richards pulling up a little bit sore after training yesterday and really putting an enormous responsibility on the shoulders of Josh Fraser to try and carry this ruck division. And speak the devil, there he is, in between Brad Gotch and Nick Malthouse. So the margin is 47 points. Alan Didak and inside the centre square, and along with Travis Cloak, who'll do the ruck work for the final part of this third quarter. He wins it down. Sharked though by James McDonald, who had more time than he thought. He was able to get it wide. Chris Johnson couldn't quite hold on. Buckley keeps his feet. Little shepherd for Pendlebury. Buckley. Clever little kick out wide to Loney. Didak. Forced to kick on his non-dominant side. Didn't get any penetration.
No.
It's taken by Carroll.
But good pressure by James McDonald. Just harassed Didak enough to make sure the kick didn't carry any distance.
And Melbourne doing what they had to do here to end a wonderful quarter. They have taken control of this match against the Magpies and are certainly showing the footy world that they mean business this year.
Well, what a wonderful quarter of football by the Demons, and their midfield just took control. And once they got it up forward, they had some very, very dangerous players. They kicked 7 goals for the quarter, the Demons. And it's the first time this year that Collingwood has looked a rabble. Now, what can Mick Malthouse do? Can he turn it around in this last quarter?
Well, the Magpies will look forward to a week off and then a massive game against the Sydney Swans coming up in a couple of weeks on Network 10.
10 is your home of big-time football.
That's no mistake.
Saturday night football, Telstra Stadium, Sydney versus Collingwood. The biggest games are here on the home of the AFL Premiership, Network 10. Sunday, the home of great Australian stories, presents a much talked about world movie premiere.
We're trying to find the murderers who killed our mother.
A family under police suspicion.
A family under public scrutiny.
A family whose secrets will shock you.
Why isn't anyone on our side?
Georgie Parker.
Alex Dimitriadis.
And Matthew Lenevis.
The Society Murders, 8:30 Sunday on 10.
Another moment of genius from Toyota. Most memorable grand final moment of all time. Specky of all Speckies, taken by another
Jezza!
Man. Alex Jezelenko.
Jezelenko!
Jezelenko! Dave, can you... It's 1970, Blues versus Pies. Now, Jezza, you stand here. I'll be Mackay. And Dave, you can be Jerka Jenkins. You happy? It's not... Dave. Dave, that was a really good suit. You've lost a little bit of the spring in your step.
Spring!
But I think all we need is leverage.
A little bit of leverage for Jezelenko!
You beauty!
Oh, Jezza!
What could go wrong? Nothing. No, that's not going to work. Not much height there.
No, it's time for plan B.
That's beautiful.
Mackay kicks it to the wing position. Oh, Jezza!
Jezza! You beauty!
Hey, boys, boys. Wow. Hey.
Yes!
Nice grab.
The computer detected some irregular spending on Fiona Taylor's credit card.
Ah, simultaneous transactions in Melbourne and Singapore.
So I called her and she confirmed Singapore wasn't hers. Then I cancelled her card and issued a new one.
It's time then.
For the Falcon.
Every ANZ credit card is protected 24/7 by Falcon, our security program that helps reduce credit card fraud. More convenient banking. That's ANZ now.
Harvey Norman's ripping back prices in our big half-yearly clearance. Buy now and save with 19 months, no deposit, no interest, no repayments till January 2008. Electrical, computers, furniture and bedding. We are ripping back prices to clear the lot. Huge reductions on overstocks and run-out lines. With 19 months, no deposit, no interest, no repayments till January 2008. What a deal. Massive savings and 19 months interest-free. Rip into Harvey Norman's big half-yearly clearance and save on now.
You know what I love about Subway restaurants? Same thing you do. Great tasting food and lots of it. They've got tons of choices, so you can get something different every day. I'm gonna go check out what deal they have today. Now this is a deal worth walking all the way across town for.
The $3.50 daily special. Every day, a different delicious, great tasting 6-inch Subway sub on fresh baked bread, fresh toasted and made the way you like it for just $3.50. 7 days, 7 great 6-inch subs, all for the one daily special price of just $3.50.
Subway, eat fresh.
Network 10 Adelaide would like to thank the support of their local sponsors. Stratco, what do you need today? Make it your way. Subway, eat fresh. Truscott's and TEAC, the plasma LCD and surround sound specialists. And Booze Brothers, proudly South Australian owned.
Big crowd and a big result for the Demons. 17-7, 109 to 9-8, 62. A quarter to go, but the Demons really emerging today as serious contenders. The Magpies putting in their first real shocker for the season so far. Still a quarter to try and change things. And in that third quarter, plenty to worry about for Mick Malthouse. But things were just going Melbourne's way. Adam Uzejewicz scored a fantastic goal. It wouldn't go astray in Kaiser Slouten tonight. Think Colin were in trouble when you saw this one go through, Mike?
Yeah, I think that about summed it up, Hutto. It was, he's played a wonderful game, hasn't he? Three goals in that third quarter and four for the game.
Four multiple goal kickers. Pickett with two, Davey three, Neitz three, and Uze four. Here's the leading match winners for the Demons.
And real strength of the Melbourne midfield. Cameron Bruce, he's played centre-half, back and midfield. Brad Green's been in the middle. Travis Johnson, terrific with the clearances. Phil Reed, hard and tough. And Bate, first-year player, has just been exceptional. Probably more bad news for Collingwood at this centre bounce. They haven't got Josh Fraser. It's Travis Cloak to do the ruck work.
Well, I wonder if what Mick Malthouse is thinking for this last quarter. Pendlebury in the middle there, Iacobucci, Cloak. So he's given the young players some pretty key roles in this last term, maybe just to find out what they can do. Rivers for White. And Ward, who came into the team for Whelan today and has done a terrific job. Travis Johnston, one of their prime movers.
Buckley playing across half back on Dunn.
20th possession for the day for Travis Johnston. Just calling Dunn up forward, forcing him to lead almost. Presti's done a pretty good job on Neitz, despite the fact that the Melbourne captain has three goals. There's White. And Byron Pickett, such a wild card, isn't he, for the Demons? If he's up and running, just so hard to control. Nitz makes his move, but White the option. Now Rivers is going to get a chance for his second shot at goal. Try and kick two for the day.
They've been too smart, Melbourne, for the Collingwood team today. They've stuck to the game plan, which is be patient. Don't kick it to a contest. Spot a teammate up with a short pass. We know we'll win the clearances if it becomes a ruck contest. And Jared Rivers, the centre half back, having his second shot for goal after his second mark inside the forward 50.
And he goes sailing ahead of Rod Carter on the all-time goal kickers list.
People who know their numbers know now's the time to buy Toyota.
Seven.
Seven-seat Kluger all-wheel drive V6 CV auto. Now just $39,990 while Toyota means business. We travel the world to bring you the delicious taste of Italy. The special edition Parmigiana sub. Yumma mia. Parmigiana combo. Just $6.95. Taste the world at Red Rooster.
So the margin back out to 53 points.
Can't work that one out, Sauce. Nathan Buckley playing in the back pocket for the Magpies. There's only one person who'd be happy about that.
Well, he's on Dunn, and Dunn's just taking him straight to the square.
White kicks towards half forward. Coming out to meet it is Dunn. Now Davey slipped the Lockie attacker. Aaron Davey blistering speed. Kicks across the face. Misses everything, so he'd be disappointed with that after setting it up beautifully.
Melbourne coach Neil Danaher would just be thrilled to see Buckley playing on that last line of defence for the Pies.
So Cloak, long towards the wing, low, little push out. Not paid. McDonald, who's been wonderful today. Carroll. Oh. Escaped the Davis tackle and then drills it out wide to Johnston, who has played a blistering second half. Travis Johnston has got time on the southern half forward flank. Wobbly old kick though. Buckley can chop it off. Travis Cloak just off a step and gets to Yakabuchi. O'Bree. Not much to go to, so he waits for Pendlebury, who is also confronted by Bartram. And again, Collingwood turn it over, and Melbourne do extremely well. Clint Bartram is going to star again today. 13 disposals, 5 marks.
And have a look at that bloke. You talk about disposals. Anthony Rock has had 2. And we've gone into the fourth quarter, Steve. They've just got to get him into the action. Get him in there and bowl a few over at least.
I'm with you, Rob.
Pendlebury to half forward. Then Didak, who's been the most likely now, over the ball there.
It'll be interesting to see this, Rob, whether it was high or whether he copped him on the side.
I reckon it was on the side. I reckon Junior McDonald pulled up a little bit.
Yeah, on the side.
Dale Thomas will have a shot at goal.
Kick for the high contact, okay? Just saying, go back at him.
Not sure if we've got 7-second delay or not on TV, like we do on radio. I don't think so, is the answer. Dale Thomas kicks a goal.
Some brothers are famous for their driving prowess. We're famous for great booze prices. Like Crown Lager, just $43.99 a carton. Choose any 2 bottles of Ballantine Scotch Whiskey, Smirnoff Vodka, Cougar Bourbon or St. Agnes 5-year-old VSOP Brandy for only $50. Or Berry 5-litre casks, just $18 a twin pack. Booze Brothers, we know booze.
The Melbourne forward line, and they just set up in a straight line so that if they get a centre break, there's space out to the pockets and flanks for the forwards to lead into.
So back in the centre, White decisively towards James McDonald. O'Bree can't control it. Bate, very good player early. Jeff White hacks it forward. Morrison comes to meet it. Straight into left here. Now Pendlebury. Scott Pendlebury in just his second game. towards Rowe. Rivers did very well. Need to keep your feet here. Well done, Julian Rowe. Literally lost out with the weight of numbers. Green, Pickett sweeps the handball inside to White, who has a casual bounce. His handball was deflected by Pendlebury. Shaw, Bruce, got a dubious looking handball towards Green. Now Pickett, they've got the numbers, and that's why they've run out here, Melbourne. White, left foot kick, he's kicking on his left foot all this last quarter. Now Buckley, look out. He got the kick away. Little fumble from Loney. But he's got support as Pendlebury takes it out wide. Handball between Burns and Iacobucci. They work it out as Burns' little give is okay to Iacobucci. Long towards forefoot. Carroll got across and marks in the end pretty comfortably.
Really couldn't have been less impressive today, Collingwood, could they? They've been fantastic this season. I don't know whether you can you just write off today as one of those days, Rob, or have you seen signs that you don't like?
Well, I don't like the fact that Anthony Rock has just had two touches and done nothing about it. A few of their younger players have certainly struggled.
Taking nothing away from Melbourne, Rob, I think their pressure's been outstanding and they've caused the errors.
Yeah, gee, Nathan Buckley is out of touch. One-handed attempt to pick up there, not good enough.
Jamar, back for Green. The last man standing was Robertson, did everything but didn't take the mark. Now Morrison, Burns and Buckley. Almost going to be mowed down again by Bate. Again, the disposal for Rocker, not good. Rivers, off for Bruce. Calls on his teammates to present. Davey's happy to oblige. Davey looking for Johnston, but couldn't hit a target this time. Pendlebury was getting an education this last quarter by playing on Travis Johnston. Pokes it, finds Loney.
That's what's ahead of Ryan Loney. Shaw breaks for him. Southern wing. And he can keep going, Heath Shaw. Runs towards half forward, and Didak, who is arguably being Collingwood's best today, coming in for his 20th disposal. He's taken nine marks, kicked a couple of goals, and has really been their most dangerous player up forward.
Anthony Rocker should be in the goal square and has made no attempt to get down there.
Didak from hard up against the boundary line kicks across the face. So one behind there. His tally for the afternoon, 2-1. Kick comes in towards Reid. Fraser does well to affect the spoil, but the Demons are away as Reid's first to recover. Wobbly old kick, though, to side of the boot. Robertson and Clement. Free kick to Robertson. He just stumbled.
He did it well, Robinson. He knew Clement was right on his hammer, and he just allowed his legs to give way.
He just stumbled and then fell. Smart play. Now he's been called to play on, and he kicks it back to Johnston, who transfers play to Bruce. So they're working around the perimeter here of the 50-metre arc, just waiting for a way in because Collingwood have got numbers back. So Travis Johnston, still 60 from goal.
Nathan Buckley being taken off.
Get to Christie in a moment on that one.
So Johnston spots a target. Iacobucci makes a contest of it as intended for Bate. Iacobucci does very well. Burns, now he's short. And he kicks it out wide to Didak, who takes mark number 10.
Well, he hesitates because in front of him there are three Demons and just two Magpies. Ooh. There's one of them.
Very late there, Ward.
I think it's the correct decision. Looked like a bit of a forearm to the back of the head.
Hey, hang on. Yeah, I thought he marked it and I thought you got him late.
So Johnson sets it up for Fraser. Thomas is there as well. And now Davis. Thomas looking to put another one through. And he has. He's kicked a couple.
Massive.
massive stock clearance this long weekend at Stratco. With 20% off hardware, 15% off lawn and garden products, 15% off paint and accessories, and 15% off timber. There's 20% off hand tools, and a further 10% off heating's already red-hot catalog pricing. 3 days only. Hurry in and save at Stratco.
What you need today?
It's massive.
And further woes for Collingwood. Chris Tarrant has come off and is having his right ankle checked. Nathan Buckley just off for a rest. He actually went straight to the headset to get a message from the coach.
So Fraser wins this one forward, only as far as McDonald, who scrambles it towards Pickett, who has been a wonderful player today. Slips the Dinang tackle and kicks it into space at half forward. Travis Johnston, 50 metres in the clear, can turn from 30 and kick. Oh, great stuff. He's been a wonderful player in this final half. Travis Johnston kept up his great work there. His skills have been exquisite, and he really has been the architect behind this Melbourne second half. They led by 26 points at half time, but it was their third quarter which was blistering, and he was the one behind it.
And he's coming off the ground now just to make sure he got the full amount of applause from the crowd, because they have rightfully loved him today.
Well, we've always known that he was a talent, and as each year goes by, we're seeing more and more of it delivered.
...46 points the difference. Jamar enjoying his run today in the ruck, teaming up with White. Loney, Pendlebury,
tackled
without it, getting busied out. Lockyer, the centre half forward, looking for a bit of Leon Davis. Oh, he had a crack. And at ground level, he gets it back to Didak. It was ugly, it was long, and it was straight, but it was touched. Ben Holland thought he was going to end up having a kick in there for a moment, but it's going to Daniel Ward.
So Daniel Ward looks ahead of him. He chips it short into the back pocket. Carroll. Now Godfrey.
At about 25 more marks than the opposition, Melbourne. All part of the plan to keep possession, be patient, stop the flow of Collingwood.
Bell inside the centre square.
They've done it well, Steve, haven't they?
Well, they have. I mean, and the great thing about the Doom, their ball usage, George, that all day has been spot on, and they've just rewarded the guy that's presented.
Bartram. Oh, handball just a little bit too far in front of Brad Green. He couldn't control it. He did pretty well in the end, just to toe poke it over the line for a boundary throw.
I reckon they might have learned a bit, Wolsey, from Brisbane last week. We saw, I know Brisbane got overrun in the end by the Magpies, but they played that similar game, didn't they, for a while we're on top.
McDonald, well done, controlled the footy. Drives it long towards half forward. Oh, good Mark Thomas, had to sit and wait underneath it and did it well. Good strength shown. He kicks it out wide.
The Collingwood that we've seen this year has been the most risk-taking, fast-flowing Collingwood side that Mick Malthouse has coached. And they've given us some terrific thrills the way that they've played, kicked some big scores. But I think opposition teams are starting to wake to them.
Rocker.
And we've seen it the last 2 weeks.
Couldn't take that one. Oh, well done by Carroll, coming through like a steam train. Now done. And his handball intended for Godfrey, just missed the mark. But Godfrey did superbly to get it to Davey. Now Dunn's a chance. Can he pick the loose footy up? No. Good stuff from Thomas. Ooh, stripped him of the footy. He was well tackled in turn. And we'll get a bounce. Haven't seen too many holding the ball decisions where players have been lying on top of the ball today. A couple of fumbles there from Dunn. Thomas, not much of an opportunity from the bounce. Davey, 50 from goal, checks the kick, did it brilliantly. And Bruce will kick from 55 metres on a 50-degree angle.
He's very unselfish too, isn't he, Davey? I mean, at this time of the game, you could be forgiven for him to have a crack himself.
And that's why they love him, Hutto. Jared Rivers getting massive ovation from the Demon faithful. He's had a super game, kicked a couple of goals. But Aaron Davey, he's just becoming the complete player.
So Bruce in for disposal number 25 from 30 metres. It's close, it's home. Another one to Melbourne.
Right, money, we're off. We'll see you at the party.
Yeah, no worries, fellas.
Bye.
I'll see you there. Clever, fellas. Very clever.
I like a bloke who's man enough to wear pink. Come meet my friends.
Sure. Cheers for the fashion tip, fellas. Classic.
Variety of roles for Cameron Bruce today. At the end of it, 25 possessions and two goals won. 51 points is the margin. Fraser and Jamar. Neil Danaher giving Jamar plenty of work now with the game just about done. Here's Thomas. Saw Fraser out of it. There's a whistle.
Hey, I think Anthony might get a free.
You've got Louis arm the whole time.
I saw that. You know what I mean? Well, looking at you. He's not happy, Big Ben.
Sometimes the microphones work well. So Anthony Rocker, who has had a dirty day, just one kick, one handball, two hit-outs, one tackle, and a behind. And now, a free kick and a goal.
They know that we've got enough stock here and enough variety of stock to allow them to get the right thing for the right job.
Yates 25 kilo dynamic lifter, only $16.98. DeWalt 100 mil heavy duty angle grinder, $98. Jumbuck silver patio heater, $199. 4 litre British ultra flat paint, $49.80. Gutter guards, two for just $4.
You know you're going to find the right thing you're looking for. Bunnings
Warehouse. Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Crowd today, 78,000. It is Melbourne's biggest crowd in a home and away game since 1971.
Fraser went too early. The wide kick was smothered. Spills to Thomas. Concedes ground. Lecuria, who chips it short. Pendlebury has got a lot of the footy in this final quarter. Got a raking left foot kick. Drives it long. Rocker and Holland. Rocker again. Has he paid it? No. Fraser tries to shovel it out. Row. Oh, lost the handle. Allows Melbourne in. And McDonald, Chris Johnson, who did very well to dribble it to Bruce. In half back, handled to Ward. Reed. Ward kept going. Good play, Daniel Ward. Tucked under the arm and storms from half back. Kicks it into the path of Bell. Confronted by Shaw, but he was able to get the handle over.
Catch
to Davey. Aaron Davey, one bounce. Don't tell me he'll kick this. He kicks to the goal square unselfishly over the head of Jamar and Clement. Clement does well to keep front position. Soccer towards half back. Lockyer will be first there. Handball to Prestigio Como, chips it short. Didn't get to Lecuria. Okay. And applies the pressure. Well done by Presti. Came into support. Well, Jamar finds himself with the footy. Collingwood got 4-on-2 out there.
Well, Pickett was great. Fantastic, Pickett.
Well, look at the scoreboard. They're that far in front and they're still playing like this. It's a mighty effort by Melbourne.
Some very big ones to come for the Magpies. Going to be a beauty. Round 12 in a couple of weeks at the Telstra Dome, and then the Rampant Tigers and the Saints before the Dockers. Now Godfrey to full forward. Green waits down. He's got the chance now. Oh, Travis Johnston just came off the bench in the right place at the right time. Travis for another one.
Can't do a thing wrong, the coach, can he? Makes the moves and the player bobs up in a bit of space. Melbourne just dominated the hit-outs, though, Steve, today.
Well, they have. 37 to 15. Jamar has been sensational in that area.
Shaw, Fanloni, and now Lecuria. Play on the call, no free kick. McDonald back for Uze, back for McDonald. Johnston's worked into some space again on the wing. He and Bruce options. Bruce wanted 50. Doesn't get it. It's got Jamar, who's pushed inside the 50, as we mentioned a moment ago. And instead for Uzay. Meeks is still deep. And
this is what they've done all day. They just transfer the football across to the other side.
Magpies have pushed some numbers back inside the defensive 50.
Geez, a gifted player, Cameron Bruce.
There's Meeder back in the square with Presti.
Here they go again. Collingwood haven't woken up to this. It's been happening for four quarters. Collingwood haven't got a player in their forward half, and yet Melbourne, they just keep putting the ball back, don't they?
Well, they do. They know that Collingwood sit across that half back line, so what they either try and do is get a long kick to the deep to the goal square, which they do here. Takes those guys out of the action.
Bruce, the flyer, sure, well done with Morrison. And eventually the kick hacked out of defence, but it's going to be all Melbourne across there. Johnson probably could have been a bit cleaner. He gets the footy anyway. Leon Davis on the mark. Now wide for Bartram. And again, we had this ring-a-ring-a Rosie. We saw Adelaide do this to Collingwood.
Yes.
Back in the first round.
And they'll be happy just to keep putting the ball back. 8 goals in front.
Cameron Bruce coming off. That's what the applause are for. Not that many Collingwood fans left at the MCG. I think they might have decided to try and beat the traffic. Plenty of demons, though, as Godfrey goes wide. Wasn't a high percentage effort, that one. Well done by Rowe. Out to Burns, and now on the fast break, Leon Davis. Only space ahead of him. He had Didak away to his left. He thought he could go on his own, and he thought right.
Ten's brand new comedy hour starts with a shock.
Homer, your dad might not be your dad.
So who is Homer's real father? Brand new Simpsons, 7:30 Tuesday. Then at 8 o'clock on 10's new comedy hit The Wedge, these are just some of the wedgies Australia can't get enough of.
No, I'm gonna go, I gotta go, kids, I'm going.
New Simpsons and The Wedge from 7:30 Tuesday.
He's not too, looking too happy, is he?
Where's the coat?
Tucked away in the bag, I think, Rob.
So back in the centre, White decisively. Godfrey, little fumble. Thomas saw look away, handball spills to Davey. Kick towards the goal square. Neats and Presta Giacomo. J-Mo will kick a goal. Aaron Davey is a prodigious talent. He set so many opportunities up for Melbourne.
Now, what we're looking at there happened early in the third quarter when the Magpies got a couple of goals and a bit of a run, and Josh Fraser saying bye-bye to Jeff White.
Well, White and J-Mar have been fantastic in the hit-outs, Rob.
And there we see the see-you-later Jeff White after he marked, kicked the goal, and very, very premature, Josh, because the Demons have got the last laugh, and they have absolutely smashed Collingwood in the hit-outs.
So it's back to 46.
Jumper! Thanks, Macca. Yep, let him go down. Thanks.
And it's Pendlebury. He and Thomas have had a bit of it in the last quarter. Pendlebury, in fact, 17 possessions now.
Linden there!
This is Morrison. Loney. And Pendlebury again.
There, Linden!
So they're getting something out of it, the Magpies. Burns. Depth on the kick this time.
Big fish by Benny Holland. And now he's got rid of Rocker. He's got Tarrant as his opponent.
Anthony Rocker, who's on the bench, I presume. He is on the bench. He has played 194 games, and only three times has he not taken a mark in those 194 games. Well, he's again without a mark today. Neats spoiled by Presta Giacomo. Sure, but Neats, the big David Neitzark, back for McDonald. Now back for Johnson. And in the pocket, Travis.
Kicking skills of Melbourne, Steve, have been terrific today.
Well, they have. They've had a bit of time as well, Rob. And we just saw the amount of time they've had there. Little pressure, so they've been able to hit their targets.
Travis Johnson kicks this goal, he will turn to the faithful and say, how good was that?
Johnston. No, no turning. Keeps it back to them.
So Clement at fullback for Collingwood to Burns. Burns a leading possession winner for the Magpies with 28. Lockyer on southern wing delivers to Johnson. Good ball from Bell. Ball close to the line.
And
free kick to Melbourne. Advantage paid to Bell. So Daniel Bell with a couple of bounces around the southern wing. Kicks a probing ball towards half forward. Neats and Prestigiacomo. Well done, Prestigiacomo. Effected the tackle. Spills to Burns. And his kick intercepted by Bates, intended for the courier. So Melbourne, another chance here to build. Jeff White in the midfield. Chips it to a vacant half forward line for Collingwood. Reed takes the mark off to Byron. Thank you very much. Byron Pickett kicks another goal. And he has been an awesome player today, Byron Pickett. Haven't the Melbourne fans fallen in love with him? He's had 19 disposals, 7 marks, and has just kicked his third goal.
And his coach at Port Adelaide, Mark Williams, just felt that he might have been umpired out of the game after getting some suspensions.
Davey comes off. Here's the Melbourne matches to come. The Bombers in round 12, Port Adelaide, the Lions and the Tigers. So only one team inside the 8 from there. That's a Richmond accident. In fact, are the Tigers in the 8 at the moment? I think they're just on the edge of it anyway. So certainly plenty of winnable matches for the Demons in the next month. The thing about their forward line, Rob, we talked about Davey. What a mix of forwards they've got. They've got big Neats. They've got Robertson, who's obviously versatile. Then Davey and Pickett lurking around.
I think Dunn's been the surprise packet. He's come out to centre-half forward and, look, taken a lot of pressure off Neats and Robinson.
Well, Russell Robertson, I've got no doubt, is carrying some sort of an injury. He's had a pretty quiet game, but you know what he's capable of. And Neil Danaher's kept him out there for the bulk of the game. He's a class act.
Godfrey. And here's Bate. We've talked enough about him already today, but 23 possessions for Bate. Now, Clement. Mercurio working for him on the wing, and so is Didak. 28th possession for Paul Lecuria. Burns has had 29, but neither of them dominant players. Johnson. Oh, Didak. Coming in for possession, 23. Tarrant makes his move, and that's a good one. And that is that. The Demon fans celebrate. Still one more full stop to be applied. Never has a goal by Chris Tarrant and the MCG been booed through before. The Demons' final margin is 47 points.
It's a grand old flag, it's a high flying flag, it's the emblem for me and for you. It's the emblem of the team we love, the team of
Yeah, no doubt. We wanted our supporters to get out and we really wanted to put on a show of playing for each other, and that's what we've done today, and it was good to get away for a win.
Well, they certainly supported you. Now, Anthony Hudson thinks that the Socceroos might pick you up and take you over to Germany after that soccer goal that you kicked off the ground.
Yeah, I think it was just a little bit lucky, but no doubt we'll be following the game tonight, and yeah, hopefully they get over Japan tonight. It'll be good to watch, but yeah, once again, a big crowd for us today, and a really big day for the club, and it was just good to play some hard footy and get away for a win.
The team is really gelling. How close to your best do you think the team is playing?
obviously we always think we could play a lot better, but I don't know how many wins we've had now, but we're playing some good hard footy and hope we can keep that going to the break and then have a real good hard think about where we're going to look towards the end of the year and who knows from there.
Well, well done today.
Thank you.
Thank you, Christy. Adam Uzay, 4 goals, Byron Pickett 3, Davey 3, Meeks 3, Cameron Bruce 2, that man Travis Johnston 28 possessions. The Magpies, who have been so good this year, put in a bad one. Young Matthew Bate, 23 possessions. Rick Swan and Eddie Maguire watching on. Jared Rivers, another fine player for the Demons. So we're just about all good today. And the Demon fans who are out in force today, 78,000 people at the MCG. They got what they came for. And that was an awesome display by Melbourne. And there's your final score, 22-9 to 14-10.
Due to TAN's live telecast of the AFL, today's episode of Scope will not be seen at 4 p.m. today. You can catch the next episode of Scope at the usual time next Monday at 4 p.m.
In 10 news at 5, a rape survivor's urgent plea as South Australia's new DNA laws leave police powerless to stop a predatory rapist. A rare Queen's birthday honour for a South Australian couple. Police charge a man with murder and aiding and abetting suicide after the death of a Pennington woman yesterday. And the doctor's diagnosis on Port's latest injury woes. Join us at 5.
Housemates, it is time to nominate.
He's nastier.
And more severe.
Than ever before.
Is this the week he's going to come down hard?
The plot thickens.
Live nominations from 7 o'clock tonight on 10.
People who know their numbers know now's their time to buy Toyota.
4x2.
4x2 Hilux single cab workmate. Now even better value at 19,920 with air. Because Toyota means business.
We're for the ruck, the rover, the full forward and the full back. At Pedigree, we're for footy. And together with NAB AFL Auskick, you could be the Pedigree Natural Footy Star. You'll have the chance to attend the 2006 Toyota AFL Grand Final, play on the MCG at halftime, and much more. Visit aflauskick.com.au to see how you could win.
Looking for a way to flatten your bank fees?
National Australia Bank announces a snap freeze on fees, with no monthly account service fee for 6 months on new smart transaction accounts. This offer must defrost on 30 June 2006, so call 13 13 12 to apply now.
We travel the world to bring you the delicious taste of Italy. The special edition Parmigiana sub, yum mia. Parmigiana combo, just $6.95. Taste the world at Red Rooster.
Henry! Henry!
Whiskers VitaBites, now with Dental Protection Plus. Cats know the difference.
These guys look like they need a bit of a lift to keep them going, so I've prepared a little something with a few things I found around the place. So we've got some prawns on the go in here.
Where'd that bait get to, Pete? Put out in the sun to thaw out yesterday. Oh.
Actually, the best way to fill blokes up is with a bit of this. Let's just let go of that.
Campbell's, the experts in soup.
Mmm. That is, you know, good. Just don't touch that. How's the fishing? Still nothing?
Very hot, big, super cool, red and the blue, as we sing.
Simmons in full voice, and you can see the scoreline. Really, Collingwood kicked the first goal of the day, and after that, Melbourne got on top. And Robert Walls, as we looked through the each of the quarters, there was never really a time where Collingwood genuinely threatened, was there?
Maybe just for a couple of minutes in the third quarter, Hutto. We got a couple of quick goals there, but it was very short-lived. This Melbourne team, they were very strong today in all areas of the ground. They just dominated. On the scoreboard, they won the clearances, they won the hit-outs, their tackles were hard. They didn't give Collingwood any space, and they stuck to their game plan admirably. They just denied Collingwood the footy. They took a lot of marks, the Demons, and their foot skills, when they did go forward, were just spot on. It was just a super win by them.
Well, their pressure was fantastic. We talked about that a number of times throughout the day, and really, as you mentioned, the tackling and just the aggression at the footy.
Yes, well, they've really made a name for themselves. We're only halfway through the year, but have a look at Aaron Davey there, Byron Pickett, Cameron Bruce, Brad Green, Junior McDonald. They all have a go. They brought Philip Reid into the team for this game. He didn't let them down. He got plenty of the ball. He hit in hard. And if you're a Melbourne supporter, you'd just be so proud of the way in which they play for each other. And we heard Adam Uze say that after the game. They really do not want to let each other down. And they rattled the Pies.
Yes, well, of course, they lost the first three matches of the year, didn't they? And after that, they just got over the line against Sydney. And at that stage, they wouldn't have been thinking about finals too much. But after their performance today, you'd have to be very impressed. One of the big pickups over the summer, bit of a gamble, was Byron Pickett. We've talked about him a lot this afternoon. 19 possessions and a ranking of 6. Not surprising, he's 3 goals. And just his presence is always dangerous.
Well, I think a lot of people raised their eyebrows when Byron Pickett came to the Melbourne Football Club. I think after his season last year, which wasn't all that good with Port Adelaide, let's not forget the year before he played in that premiership and won the Norm Smith medal, I thought that perhaps his career was over. Even when he arrived at Melbourne, he looked overweight, but he's got himself really fit. He looks as if he's enjoying his football. He's been embraced by everyone at Melbourne. You can see that. They just flock to him whenever he does something special, and we're seeing that many, many times in a game. And this MCG, of course, I think the big stage suits him. Playing in front of a big crowd, yeah. 78,000 people here today at the MCG, and he just thrives on the big occasion, doesn't Byron?
If they do get to the finals, he's going to be a key player for them, isn't he?
Oh, he will be, because he's got the experience, and I just think the younger Demons just love being able to be out there with him, and they see how hard he goes at it. And the other thing about Byron, don't worry about it, he puts the wind up the opposition.
Great mix of players at the Demons. A lot to be happy about for their coach, Neil Danaher, who is down with Christy Malthouse.
Thank you, Anthony. Well, congratulations, Neil. I mean, not just an important win, but so many positives to take out of that game.
Look, it was a fantastic win. Big game, a lot of focus on it. And our young blokes stood up. As a team, we stood up, played some really hard, strong footy, and, yeah, we're in good shape.
Neil, congratulations. It was just a terrific performance, and congratulations to you in particular. I thought you coached boldly. You took some moves on there that nobody would have anticipated. Cameron Bruce playing at centre-half back on Chris Tarrant. Ben Holland doing the job on Anthony Rocker. Well done. You must feel very satisfied with that.
Really happy with our back line, Rob. They're getting the job done. Nathan Carroll is doing a fantastic job down there, and yeah, Reid and Ward come into the team today and took their chances. Look, I thought it was a very even effort.
Can you tell us a bit more about those matchups and when you decided to make those decisions on the key players? Because obviously both the talls and the smalls of the Magpies have been very damaging up forward in their success this year.
Oh, that's what we do with coaches. We sit at home and the wife talks to you, and yeah, they're moving these magnets around, and she wonders why we're not listening. We're thinking of what could...
So it was your wife who made the moves, Neil?
Yeah, she might have. She might have. But, you know, they just come to you while you're daydreaming.
Neil, it was terrific to see the game plan come off, which a big part of it was keeping possession of the ball. You had so many more marks than Collingwood. You didn't want to give them a chance to get hold of it because they're a free-flowing team. One of your veterans now, Travis Johnson, I thought he was super again.
Yeah, look, he's very good. Travis, you know, we had players that stood up at different times. You know, Adam Uze started very quietly and then he finishes with 4. Brad Green was very good in that third quarter. You know, I think a lot of our leaders, Jeff White, was very, very good. So we're getting good leadership at the the top end. We know about our young players and the middle tier getting the job done.
We talked a lot about your variety of danger players up forward. Aaron Davies just about becoming the complete package for you now, isn't he, Neil?
He probably has, Hutto, been down a little bit in his own estimations the last 2 weeks. I think the big occasion brought the best out of him today.
We commented at one stage, he's just so unselfish as well, whereas maybe in the past, you know, early in his career, you wouldn't blame him for playing on and having a shot. He just looks to lay it off at all occasions.
If you've got that much pace, you've probably got a bit more time than the average footballer, so he's got a bit of time to assess his options, but look, he was good today.
Neil, Byron Pickett, we've spoken a lot about Byron. Of course, he's played in two premierships with the Kangaroos and Port Adelaide. Did you have a chat to him before you decided to take him on?
Yes, Rob, yeah, I had a good chat with him, actually. Very keen to get him on board. And he was very keen to come over here and has really fitted in very, very well. And he's playing the sort of football that I knew he could play. He had suspensions last year and injuries, and everyone thought his career was over. But we were hoping that wasn't the case, and he's proving it at the moment. He's still got a lot of good football left in him.
78,000 people here today, Neil, and I thought that Byron Pickett led the way, and your younger players, they must love playing alongside him.
Oh, there's no doubt about that, and we got a lot of harder and a lot tougher, and we still got a lot of hard players to come back into our team, Rob, with Sylvia and Maloney and McLean and Whelan and these sort of blokes. So been really happy with our attack on the ball and our ability to tackle. We're a hard team now.
Exciting times for you, Neil. We appreciate your time. Well done again today.
Good on you, Hutto.
Neil Danaher joining us down there in the Melbourne rooms. And I know he's not showing much emotion, Neil, but I guess he'd be spent you after any day, but he'd be satisfied, wouldn't he?
Oh, I would be. Just those last three players, Sylvia, Maloney and McLean. They're all tough. They're all hard. Mm. They're all good players. And they weren't there today.
Yeah, so, and Whelan as well.
Whelan's another. Yep. Brad Miller's another player who didn't play. So no wonder he's feeling confident. And how good is it that they can win a game like that with those youngsters out there? That game today would be worth half a dozen because they played on the big occasion. The whole focus of the country was on this game today.
Take a break from the MCG. Plenty more to come. We'll turn our attention to the Magpies as well.
Escape the everyday with the Grand Vitara Trekker. This limited edition comes fully fitted with everything you need as standard. Turn every fantasy into reality. The Grand Vitara Trekker for a limited time from $28,990. So get in quick and really get away.
Toyota and RPM are giving you the chance to win the ultimate Formula One experience. VIP passes to the German Grand Prix. Plus, you get to drive a Formula One car, all valued at nearly $50,000. Log on to rpmlive.tv now to enter.
Over 60,000 new season garments must be liquidated. It's the unrivaled largest designer denim and fashion brand sale in the Southern Hemisphere. Designer jeans from a ridiculous $15 at Duncan Hall Adelaide Showgrounds from this Thursday at midday.
Oh, jump on a winner, John So. He's in the know down there with the Demons. Melbourne certainly the winners today at the MCG. What about the Magpies? Quick, we're going to have a look at some of their turnovers. They really weren't themselves today, were they?
No, they weren't. But when you look at Tarrant and Rocker and Buckley, between them, three goals, not good enough. And we just saw, in the first half, we saw about five marks that you'd expect to be taken in the forward 50, and they dropped them. So, they let themselves down. Their skills were poor.
They're going to week off now before they meet Sydney, which is going to be a massive game at the Telstra Stadium.
Yeah, it will be a big one up there, and I reckon Sydney would have learned a lot. We know that Paul Roos was here watching, and he would have been impressed with Melbourne, just the way that they played that possession game and kept the ball out of the hands and blocked the run from Collingwood's half-back line.
Well, here is the top eight at the moment. Melbourne moving up into sixth place. Collingwood have, I think, 1-3 they are against the teams that are in the top eight so far this year. They're in third, so they're still in a very good position. Richmond are not in the eighth. No, well, thanks for your support earlier, Walsy.
I wasn't sure whether they were in or out, Hutto, so
neither was I.
I didn't want to commit.
No.
not like you. Terrific game today, and a great win by the Demons. They'd be well pleased with that. Wolsey, thanks for your company.
Good on you, Hutto. Enjoyed it.
Big crowd at the MCG. 78,000 saw the Demons win. Hope you enjoyed it as well. Good night from the MCG.
The 2006 Toyota AFL Premiership season. Proudly brought to you by our broadcast partners. Toyota. Footy. Oh, what a feeling. Harvey Norman. There's a store near you. Carlton Draft. The beer behind footy. And Pedigree. We're for dogs.
Here's a sample of the teams you'll find at Vodafone City Beach, Adelaide and Mawson Lakes. Hitman Harris, Twisted, Block Party, and who could forget the Sandy Butts. These zany creatures meet regularly for a friendly game of beach volleyball.
Let's kill them!
So get your own zany team together. The new season starts soon at Vodafone City Beach and Mawson Lakes. Thanks to Volleyball SA, a not-for-profit organisation in the interests of promoting good health.
I got your feeling floating with your feet off of the ground. Mama say, mama all sing a song.
Due to 10's live telecast of the AFL, the Bold and the Beautiful will not be...